football. Bulldogs are ready to take the gridiron. The Carthage Dogs have three state championships back-to-back. Can Coach Surratt and his staff direct the Dogs to a fourth state championship in a row? You're listening to Carthage Bulldog Football on KGAS, your sports beat station for East Texas. Our broadcast is made possible in part by Panola College, State Farm Insurance, State Barber your agent, HEB, Krill's AAA Fence, XL Ford Lincoln, First State Bank and Trust Company, Courtney Construction, Farmers State Bank, Pippin Motor Company, Hills Meat Market, and Citizens Bank. Other fine sponsors making this game possible include Hartsway Hospice, Carthage Furniture, Panola National Bank, Ken Turner Pharmacy, The Filling Station, East Texas Medical Center Carthage, The Popcorn Place, Carthage Discount Tire and Brake, Toyota of Marshall, Copper Falls, and Just In Time. Larry Allen is your play-by-play announcer. Mark Harris will provide the color, and Dustin Burns will have comments from the sidelines. Our starting lineup tonight is brought to you by Panola College.
Graduates of Panola College's Oil and Natural Gas Technology program are in high demand by companies that work in a wide range of technical areas. This program was designed by industry professionals and is updated regularly to meet changing employer needs. Classroom instruction with hands-on training provides students with skills necessary to enter an industry offering great pay, benefits, and a high job placement rate. For more information about the Oil and Natural Gas Technology program at Panola College, call 903-693-2000 or click panola.edu.
Now, here's Larry Allen with your starting lineup.
All right. Thank you very much, Jerry Hansen. Your broadcast crew coming to you tonight live from Newsom Stadium, Vernon Newsom Stadium in Mansfield, Texas. Beautiful facility. It's the Class 3A Division II Region 2 Finals, Region 2 Regional Matchup against the Argyle Eagles, the Carthage Bulldogs, and the Eagles who met in the Regional Championship game last year. Round 4 of the playoffs, Carthage won that 44-27. They meet in Game 3 this year. I'll return to look at the Carthage offensive lineup after this from your sports beat station, KGAS.
Are you tired of being just another policy number? Call Tate Barber at State Farm, where we still believe in the old version of the Golden Rule. Treat others as you want to be treated. If trustworthy service is as important to you as it is to him, then go buy today. They don't want to just write your insurance. They want to take the time to customize a policy to fit your individual insurance needs and become your agent and friend for life. Call Tate Barber today at State Farm, 903-693-7555.
Also bringing you the starting lineup is Little Nut Oil Company. They have three convenient locations to serve you: Little G's, Mini Mart, Country Crossroads, and Fairplay General Store. Little Nut Oil Company also offers farm products and industrial oils and greases. That's Little Nut Oil Company of Carthage. HEB is your hometown and neighborhood grocery store where you'll always find friendly faces, affordable prices, and quality products. HEB in Carthage has the finest produce and meat combined with trustworthy brands to keep your grocery bill low. Why waste your time and gas going out of town when your local HEB has everything that you need at prices that you'll love? HEB in Carthage. Here, everything is better.
All right, we return to Mansfield's Newsom Stadium, and tonight's starting lineup, the offense first of all for the Bulldogs. Mitchell Kinlan anchors that offensive line in the middle. He's the center, 5'11", 240-pound senior. Morgan Jeans is the right guard, 6', 260-pound senior. Elzie Hicks on the left side, 6', 255-pound senior. Greg Brantley committed to TCU as the left tackle, 6'7", 310. He is a senior, and right tackle is Mario McCain, 6', 220-pound sophomore. So Kinman the center, Hicks and Jeans are the guards, Brantley and McCain are the tackles. A look at the wideouts right after this from KGAS.
Courtney Construction of Carthage knows the oil field and pipeline business. Courtney Construction provides equipment and labor for pipeline jobs, facility installations and repairs, compressor installations, pit closures and reclamations. Courtney Construction can provide the equipment, personnel, and resources required to install up to 24-inch pipe. Courtney Construction has the labor, the equipment, and the know-how. So call 903-694-2911. Courtney Construction, Highway 79 North in Carthage.
First State Bank and Trust Company, we understand how important a dependable, independent bank is to growing families, farms, and businesses. That's the reason you find a level of respect and customer service here that is uncommon today. If that sounds like the kind of strong, can-do bank you're looking for, come let us show you more. A lot more. First State Bank and Trust Company, Carthage. Deep in the heart of Panola County. Member FDIC.
For the Bulldogs, Clint Cage is a tight end, 6'2", 200-pound senior. 22 receptions this year, 323 yards, 4 touchdowns. One of the wideouts, Ed Pope, 72 receptions, 1,144 yards, 15 touchdowns, only 3 shy of the mark set by Jalen Cleveland last year, 18 touchdown receptions. And the other wideout is going to be Tasker Shannon, 14 receptions, 300 yards, 1 TD. All right, Shannon and Pope, the wideouts, Clint Cage, the tight end. A look at the backfield right here. This from KGAS.
Since 1951, Pippin Motor Company has been serving you, the residents of Panola and surrounding counties. Hi, I'm Will Blackwell, and I want to personally invite you to buy your next newer pre-owned vehicle from us. Quality GM products, top dollar for trade-ins, low interest rates, large rebates, and a no-pressure sales experience. What better place to buy your next new or pre-owned vehicle? That's Pippin Motor Company across from Panola College, 693-6691, or on the web at pippinmotorcompany.com.
Ken Turner Pharmacy on the Square in downtown Carthage has what you need to make you feel better. Not only will Ken Turner Pharmacy fill your prescription promptly, they'll also deliver it to your door. That way you can stay in bed and get better. Whether it's medication you need or a special gift from our gift shop that no one else will have, stop by Ken Turner Pharmacy. Ken Turner Pharmacy on the Square in Carthage, where Carthage's finest tradition.
Blake Bogenschutz, a sophomore, is the starting QB for the Bulldogs and has been the entire year. 6 footer, 180 pounds, 168 of 303 through the air for 2,534 yards, 23 touchdowns, 10 passes picked off. He's also rushed for 2 touchdowns, and he has 2 receptions for touchdowns this year. Peyton Klassen is the fullback, 5'8", 175, a junior. And the tailback, another sophomore, 5'9", 170, that's Tevin Pipkin, 225 rushes. 1,572 yards, 10 touchdowns, 18 receptions, 252 yards, and 1 TD reception through the air. All right, that's the Bulldog offense. We'll look at the defense right after this from KGAS, your sports beat station.
Have you visited Carthage Furniture lately? Carthage Furniture is the huge store behind the car wash on West Panola. Monty Bacon and his fine staff offer you a large selection of Ashley and Lane recliners. With more than 40 in stock, you have a great selection of colors, styles, and sizes starting at $299. Monty suggests you sit in the all-new high-back, wing-back Lane recliner starting at just $299. For the big man, your recliner starting at only $599. Carthage Furniture, the huge store behind the car wash on West Panola.
All right, for 28 years, Panola National Bank has been an active partner in our community, working in civic organizations, schools, and churches, helping Panola County and its citizens with their financial needs. Community banking is basic to America, and we are proud of our success. As the Bulldogs, Bearcats, Tigers, Yellow Jackets, and Mustangs realize goals with teamwork, we at Panola National Bank rely on our team members. We invite you to come in and meet them. As a reminder, we open a little earlier and stay a little later for your convenience. Member FDIC and an equal housing lender.
All right, we're coming to you live from Newsom Stadium in Mansfield, Texas. The Class 3A playoffs between the Argyle Eagles and the Carthage Bulldogs. Here's a look at the defensive line. Dakota Hart, one of the defensive end, 61 tackles, 13 for loss, 4 sacks this year, 6'2", 235, a senior. The rush end is Chad Adams, 5'9", 165, a senior, 55 tackles, 13 for loss, and 2 sacks. And the two tackles are going to be Mario McCain, 5'11", 240-pound sophomore, and Kalen Ware, a 5'11", 225-pound junior. We'll look at the linebackers when Bulldog football returns on KGAS.
When you're looking for high-quality personal care from people on whom you can depend, choose East Texas Medical Center in Carthage. The employees are people you know and trust. ETMC Carthage, an East Texas medical tradition. Here when you need them, yet able to refer you when circumstances arise. ETMC Carthage, a tradition of excellence, enhanced by becoming part of a system. ETMC Carthage, proud sponsors of the Carthage High School Battling Bulldogs.
Just-in-time sanitation services has just what you need for residential, construction, commercial, oil field, and special events. From portable toilets to roll-off dumpsters, storage containers, holding tanks, and hand-washing stations, Just-in-time sanitation can help. Dial 903-693-9991. Our commitment is to serve you. Serving all of East Texas and Western Louisiana, Just-in-time sanitation service has what you need to keep it clean and functioning. 903-693-9991. It will be done just in time.
If you don't have an oil well, you need to get one. So Ricky and Casey Bagley of Bagley Well Services can help you take care of it. Bagley Well Services is a complete service. Hookups, pipelines, maintenance, backhoe, dozer, and pipe hauling. Bagley Well Service, one call, does it all. 903-622-4122. So if you have an oil well, let Bagley Well Services do the work for you. 903-622-4122.
All right, let's take a look at that Bulldog defense. Trent Jackson is going to be in the middle as the Mike backer, 5'11", 200-pound junior, 139 tackles, 11 for loss, 1 sack, 1 interception, and 1 forced fumble. Justin Williams, 5'11", 200-pound senior, is the wheel backer, 106 tackles, 7 for loss, and 1 pass picked off. And the sound backer, and he's replacing Ricky Ingram, who was lost to the Bulldogs about 4 or 5 games ago, D.K. Callaway, 5'8", 170-pound junior. So the linebackers, Jackson and Callaway juniors, and Justin Williams, a senior. We'll take a look at the secondary right after this from your sports beat station, KGAS.
Are you or a loved one suffering from a life-limiting illness? Let Heartsway Hospice be there for you. Our experienced and compassionate team of nurses, social workers, home health aides, and chaplains will help guide you through the difficult days ahead. For more information, please call our office in Carthage, 903-690-9924. You will not walk alone with Heartsway Hospice.
Walsh Sparks at XL Ford in Carthage. For the best selection of cars and trucks in the Ultratex, power, performance, economy, there's nothing like a Ford. XL Ford in Carthage has the best parts, service department in the Ultratex. If you haven't driven a Ford lately, let me personally invite you to come by and take a test drive. Check us out on the internet. We will match or beat any deal in the Ultratex. Still on the South Loop and still number one. God bless America and simplify.
At Citizens Bank in Carthage, we want you to not only feel like a customer, but like one of our extended family. Citizens Bank would like to help you build that dream home, buy a first home, or relocate to a larger residence. The friendly loan staff at Citizens Bank can make those dreams come true. Come by our Carthage location and speak to Sonia Hawthorne about your options. Citizens Bank is an equal housing lender, member FDIC.
Because we stand for your success.
Well, the Carthage secondary is really going to be tested tonight because Argyle has an outstanding passing attack. Dominic Collins is one corner. He's a 5'10", 170-pound junior. The other corner is a senior. That's Michi Bowman, 5'8", 165. Strong safety is Tasker Shannon, 72 tackles this year, 3 for loss, and he has a pass interception. Shannon is a 6-foot, 185-pound senior. And the free safety going both ways, Ed Pope, 6'3", 175 pounds, another senior. So three seniors and a junior in the secondary for the Bulldogs, and they're going to be busy tonight. We'll return to Newsom Stadium in Mansfield right after this from KGAS.
Hello, this is Melinda Leslie with Copper Falls & Company, a full-service jewelry and gift store located on the Carthage Square. We also buy gold and silver. Gold has never been this high. Take advantage of these high prices. Come by to see us. Let us weigh your gold and silver, make you an offer. You're under no obligation. We understand that a lot of people want to save their jewelry in a lockbox for their children or grandchildren, but usually they have their own jewelry to wear. So why not sell your gold, take a trip, enjoy life, it's way too short. Give us a call, 903-693-9944.
What's your biggest concern when the weather is cold? A problem with your heater or electrical system? Well, Hal and Bruce Whitaker are the names you know and trust to calm your fears. Hal and Bruce at Hal's AC and Electric know electricity. They'll help you stay warm and keep your systems running properly. Whether it's residential, commercial, industrial, or oil field work, Hal's AC and Heating is the one to call at 903-693-7451. Quick, dependable service. They sell Amana, Train, and Goodman, but service all brands. Hal and Bruce Whitaker, the names that you know and trust.
The Argyle Eagles are one of the Bill's Meat Market in Carthage is ready to process your deer, wild hog, or elk, providing regular cuts, smoked sausage,
even summer sausage and jerky. Remember, by law, you must deliver your kill skinned, gutted, and in an ice chest. Bill says it's time to order those holiday hams and turkeys, smoked, fried, or fresh. Catering is also available for the holiday parties. Bill's Meat Market and Catering, 1317 West Panola, 693-6122. Bill's in Carthage. They have great food.
The Argyle Eagles are the opponent tonight for the Bulldogs, and they're one of the premier teams in the state. The last 3 years, they are 36-3 in 09. They went 12-0, lost in the third round of the playoffs, wound up, of course, 12-1. Last year, they were 13-0 going into the regional championship game. And that game was, of course, won by the Bulldogs, so they wound up 13-1 this year. They are 11-1. They're only lost to Prosper. However, they haven't played as difficult a schedule as the Bulldogs. Bulldogs were playing four top 10 teams this year in Lindale, Henderson, Gilmer, and also Chapel Hill. And the Argyle Eagles have faced Prosper twice. That's an outstanding team. They lost to Prosper in the regular season by 21 points, came back to beat them last week in the second round of the playoffs by a game score of 40-24. They are coached by Todd Rogers in his eighth year. He has them in the playoffs now for eight consecutive years. He's 85-26 at Argyle, and no doubt about it, the spark plug of their team is Austin Ani. Ani, who is also an all-state baseball player at both pitcher and shortstop. 154 of 270 this year through the air for over 2,400 yards, 27 touchdowns, 5 passes picked off going to TCU. And we forced him into a mediocre performance last year. 8 of 24 only was against the Bulldogs, and we're going to have to put him in some pressure situations tonight also. We'll turn to Newsom Stadium in Mansfield right after this from your sports beat station, KGAS.
Basic Energy Services of East Texas serves East Texas and Northern Louisiana with quality, dependable oil field service. Their services include acidizing, cementing work, workover rigs, and hauling salt water. If you have an oil well in East Texas, you need to know Basic Energy Services of East Texas. Basic Energy Services, proud supporters of all our area schools.
There's never been a better time to buy a new Camry than right now at Marshall Toyota. I'm Danny Cole, and today you can buy a 2011 Camry LE fully loaded with a $1,000 rebate and zero interest. If you lease, you'll get a special lease payment. Our selection is good, our staff is great, and ready to give you more details. Our service after the sale is second to none. Call us at 903-938-9026, on the web at marshalltoyota.com, or better yet, visit us at 5015 East End Boulevard, South in Marshall.
Tires are not all the same, and neither are tire dealers. So find a dealer who carries Michelin and BF Goodrich tires. Michelin offers safe, fuel-efficient, long-lasting tires that provide exceptional performance and extraordinary value. BF Goodrich tires are built for drivers looking for high performance and aggressive styling. Next time you need tires, don't deal with amateurs. See the tire experts at Carthage Discount Tire and Brake. Stop on by or visit their website at CarthageDiscountTire.com.
The introduction of officials tonight brought to you by Mark West Energy Partners. Mark West Energy Partners is an independent operator of large diameter, low pressure gathering systems interested in keeping our Panola County gas bills at a minimum. Mark West Energy Partners is also a proud Bulldog booster.
All right, the officiating crew for tonight's ball game is from College Station. Referee is James Meyer, umpire Reggie Adams, head linesman Mike Pitts. The line judge is Scott Saxby, and Stephen Zaig is the back judge. Again, James Meyer, the head man, the referee. Broadcast partner Mark Harris, himself a former Bulldog, and participated in a lot of playoff games. All right, Mark.
Well, it's going to be a big game tonight. I can tell you right now, Argyle, last year we came over here and in the Dallas area, and well, we did it at Tyler, didn't we? And we beat them pretty handily at the end of the game. Their quarterback at that time was a junior at the time. But we have played four teams in the top 10, and this is the fifth team that we were playing in the top 10 in the state of Texas this year. And incidentally, Henderson's ahead 21-0 against Salina right now. That's a team in our district. Gilmer's playing Van Alstine, is that how you say it?
Yes, sir.
There's projected to win that one. And our district is really bode well. We also scrimmaged Kilgore this year. They won today in the third round of the playoffs. So I think, like Larry said earlier, that we do have a tougher resume on us. But last year, the quarterback had a lackluster performance against us, and we made him that way. We shut his run down. If we shut the run down tonight, by the way, he's got 5 interceptions, that quarterback, and 3 of them happened in the first game against Prosper. So he's only had 2 since that time. And I was talking to one of the coaches about that first loss, and he says that they gave the game away. Said they muffed a snap on the punt for the first time, and it got to the 10-yard. Prosper scored then, threw an interception all in for a touchdown, a pick six, and so all of a sudden they were down 14-0 in that game real quick, and it went south from there. But I know tonight, bogey zone, we're going to be very tough to beat. Our defense has been shutting people down that score 60 points. Chapel Hill scores 60 points a week. We shut them down. Henderson, who's scoring 21 already in the first quarter, we shut them down basically. So our defense has stepped up to the task most of the season. So I expect a good game tonight. We're hoping we're in it, and I think we possibly could win it. And this team is 10-1 and lost to the same team who they beat handily last week. So I'm looking forward to this as we're getting ready for the coin toss. Bulldogs have come on the field, and they're under their Bulldog, fixing to run out. About 3 minutes away from kickoff. We also need to go down to Dustin and see how things are doing on the field.
Okay, yeah, Dustin, let's go down to you. What's it like down there?
He's talking. Not getting
it. Okay, we're not getting Dustin right now. So I tell you what, we'll take a break. We'll come back to Newsom Stadium in Mansfield right after this from your sports beat station, KGAS.
Tires are not all the same, and neither are tire dealers. So find a dealer who carries Michelin and PF Goodrich tires. Michelin offers safe, fuel-efficient, long-lasting tires that provide exceptional performance and extraordinary value. PF Goodrich tires are built for drivers looking for high performance and aggressive styling. Next time you need tires, don't deal with amateurs. See the tire experts at Carthage Discount Tire and Brake. Stop on by or visit their website at CarthageDiscountTire.com.
Your coin toss tonight is brought to you by Carthage Towing and Wrecker Service, offering 24-hour wrecker service for all light, middle, and heavy-duty wrecker needs. Call 903-693-9242 or 903-754-1391. Carthage Towing and Wrecker Service.
All right, we're having the reenactment of the coin toss, which took place at 6:42 tonight. I tell you what, here at Mansfield, they have everything planned out. They have a schedule of what happens and at what time. And so the coin toss already handled with the referee and the two coaches a little bit earlier. And we have the captains out there now. And they did toss it up in the air. Well, maybe they didn't have to.
It says a mock on the itinerary sheet. Looks like they're going to go to us first.
All right, looks like the Bulldogs won the toss. And they did, and Carthage will get the football. Carthage will get the football, and they'll be defending the goal to our left here at Newsom Stadium as we get underway here in just a minute. We have not had the national anthem yet, and I assume that is yet to come. Yes, that is scheduled to be next. And then the Bulldogs will get the football in this third-round playoff game between the Bulldogs and the Argyle Eagles.
Now, this is something we've been waiting for. Argyle got a bad taste in their mouth from us beating them last year. And now we're going to have the national anthem.
We invite you to remove your hats and join the Carthage High School Marching Band under the direction of Nick Durham as they will help us honor America with our national anthem.
Well, I thought I had some crowd noise earlier, but I guess I don't.
Attention hunters, Bill's Meat Market in Carthage is ready to process your deer, wild hog, or elk, providing regular cuts, smoked sausage, even summer sausage and jerky. Remember, by law, you must deliver your kill skinned, gutted, and in an ice chest. Bill says it's time to order those holiday hams and turkeys. smoked, fried, or fresh. Catering is also available for the holiday parties. Bill's Meat Market and Catering, 1317 West Panola, 693-6122. Bill's in Carthage. They have great food.
Basic Energy Services of East Texas serves East Texas and Northern Louisiana with quality, dependable oil field service. Their services include acidizing, cementing work, work over rigs, and hauling salt water. If you have an oil well in East Texas, you need to know Basic Energy Services of East Texas. Basic Energy Services, proud supporters of all our area schools.
And our pause is that the band is playing the national anthem right now. Our wireless mics are not working this evening for some reason.
Dustin might come closer and give us a report occasionally.
Okay, that's the national anthem here from Newsom Stadium in Mansfield, Texas. Having a little bit of trouble with our wireless mics. We'll try to get that worked out. We're about ready to play football. The Bulldogs won the toss, and they'll be getting it first, defending the goal to our left here. Carthage coming in with a record of 9-3. The Bulldogs winners of 20 straight playoff games. They are 21-1 in playoff action in Coach Surratt's 5 years here in Carthage, going, of course, 1-1 the first year, 6-0 the second year, state championship, 6-0 third year, state championship, 6-0 last year, state championship, and then 2-0 this year. Once again, if you just joined us, Henderson up 21-0 over Salina.
Yeah, and their quarterback being played. Their quarterback just went down with a leg injury there. I'm getting a text.
All right.
So, but of course, with a 21-point lead, surely they can hang on to that.
Henderson and Salina. Their game started at 6 o'clock, that game being played over at Mesquite Memorial Stadium. The other District 16-3A representative, Gilmer, will face Van Alstine at 7:30 at Forney City Bank Stadium. All right, Headland ready to kick off. Cole Headland, a sophomore, ready to kick off for the Argyle Eagles. They're in black pants, white jerseys, black numbers. They wear a black helmet, and the Bulldogs are in all red with white numbers. And, of course, they wear a red helmet. All right, here's the kick taken on one hop by Bowman at the 20. This is Chore to the 30, and he's out to the 33-yard line. That was Sammy Chore taking it on one hop to the from the 20, taking it out to the 33, a 13-yard return.
Kind of a pooch kick, landed about the 30, 25, and in the air. Michi got it. Had a little bit of a seam there, went through it. Good field position to start the game here at the past the 30-yard line.
All right, so the Bulldogs will have it at their own 33. Ball will be on the left hash. And, of course, the offensive line for the Bulldogs, Kinman at center, Jeans and Hicks the guards, Brantley and McCain are the tackles. Bogan shoots, starts under center. Twins to the right side. One receiver, that's Pope, split out to the left with single coverage. Pipkin is the tailback. Hand off Pipkin, going left. Gets to the outside of the 35 and is pushed out in front of the Argyle bench after a gain of about 5 yards.
Made a good move on the outside. The outside linebacker came up the field the hole. He cut to the outside. So we'll take that all night out of Tevin. 5 yards.
Gain of almost five. We'll call it five out to the Carthage 38-yard line. 11 seconds into the ball game here in Mansfield. Carthage second down and five from their own 38. Michi Bowman splits to the right. Clint Cage is going to be the tight end on the right side. And a wide out left goes motion right. That's Tasser Shannon. Bogan shoots under center. Throws left. And this one is incomplete. Out there intended for Pope. And he got tangled up with a cornerback. And it'll be third down.
I don't know how they couldn't call that. I mean, that was definitely, the ball was in the air. And he was holding on to it. But to no avail. It'll be third now for the Dogs.
Third down and five. Third and five for Carthage at their own 38-yard line. Carthage going into the win here in the first quarter. Bogan shoots, going to operate now from the shotgun. We've got two receivers to the left. Pope with single coverage is to the right. Pipkin in the backfield with Bogenschutz. Snap back to Bogenschutz. Bogenschutz throws to the near side. Incomplete. That was intended, I believe, for Pope. And it'll bring up fourth down and five, and we'll kick it away.
There was a timing route, and he threw the ball a little bit sooner than he should have. May have been pressured to. Pope turned out, went down and out. And when the ball, when he turned, the ball was about 2 yards away from him. So the Bulldogs will punt into the wind. And I watched the punter earlier, and that ball gets up, and it just kind of falls straight down. We had trouble receiving the kick.
All right, they have two men back very deep. In my opinion, against the wind, they're back too deep. And here's a low snap, the rugby-style kick by Gonzalez. We get a great roll. It hit at the 40. It's now across the 30, and it's going to be down at the 29-yard line. That's not a bad punt of 33 yards, no return.
That was good punt. Ball just rolled, rolled, and rolled, and that's what we needed. Now, come on, defense. Stiffen up here. Get after this running attack. Coach told me if they shut the run down, then they'll get after this quarterback.
All right, 32-yard kick, no return. And Austin Ani is in the shotgun now for the Argyle Eagles. Trips to the right, one to the left. He hands off to the running back coming to the left. This is Eveleth, and Eveleth is brought down after a 5-yard gain by Justin Williams.
Yeah, Justin coming from his outside linebacker position, squirted through there, and made the tackle unassisted, but not before it was a pretty good gain.
Tyler Eveleth is a senior, 152 rushes this year, 914 yards, 8 touchdowns. Argyle quickly up to the line of scrimmage. It's second and five for them at their own 35. Ball on the left hash. Here's Oney. Looks right, throws left, and it's caught. And then a smashing tackle there by Justin Williams. No, it's going to be incomplete. Incomplete pass.
He put a vicious hit on him. His back hit first, and the ball came dislodged. That was just a good play by Justin Williams right there on the coverage out there in the flat. So third down.
It's going to be third down now. Third down and five. Big hit that time by Justin Williams. Third down and five for Argyle at their own 35-yard line. Snap back to Oney. Oney looking over the middle. He throws, and this one is caught, and it's going to be, our coaches are saying incomplete, but it's going to be a complete pass, but it's going to be fourth down. Well, it's going to be short of the first down marker.
It's going to be short of the first down. They're going to be fourth and short. They are bringing their, look like their punt team or a different set up in. They do have an excellent punter from what Dustin was telling me. No score here.
Okay, Dustin, if you can hear us, we're going to go down to you after this punt and see if that pass looked to be incomplete to you. Okay, they're going to go for it here on fourth down. Going for it with a full house backfield. Here's a handoff to the running back, and he barely got it. Here's a flag coming in.
That's got to be a hold from the outside here.
A flag comes in from the near side. This is a really big call here because he has the first down if the penalty is against Carthage.
Well, they let the play run, so his offside's against us, or he's pointing against us. So they'll take. Our coaches were wild on that last pass play, saying he did not catch it. And anyway, penalty from the outside. I don't know. Maybe we were on the field. That was an odd. I've never seen that signal right there. It's like we had people on the field or something.
All right, first and 10 for Argyle at their own 45 after the 5-yard penalty. Here's the handoff to Eveleth. Eveleth trying the right side, and he is pushed back after he got about half a yard.
Chad Adams there on the tackle, also coming up out of the pile is Jackson, who had a heck of a game last week. So that's going to be now second long. 9:58 here in the first quarter, no score.
All right, we'll give Eveleth 1 yard there. Second down and nine, second and nine and a half for Argyle at their own 45-and-a-half-yard line. Oney again in the shotgun. Wide out right goes motion left. Here's Oney, play action fake. He rolls to his right. He wants to throw it. Now he's going to run with it midfield, and it steps out of bounds just before he gets to the first down marker at the Carthage 48-yard line.
Yeah, he bootlegged out of there, and we had a man in pursuit, but you can tell he's got speed. But I'm really surprised he stepped out right there. I'm surprised he didn't lower his head and try to get a first down.
So that brings up third and three now for Argyle at the Carthage 48. Ani again in the shotgun. He has two receivers to each side. Eveleth, the running back, is with him in the backfield. Third down and three. Here's the handoff to Eveleth. Eveleth trying for the first down. I think he's got it at the 45-yard line.
Depends on which leg the umpire marks it on, but it looks like, and they're calling it a first down. So they have a couple of first downs here on their first drive. We're making them work for it, though.
First down and 10 now for Argyle. Two first downs on this drive, as Mark said. 9:14 to go in the first quarter. Argyle first and 10 at the Carthage 45-yard line. Ani in the gun. Snap back to him. Play action fake. He wants to throw in the middle, and this one is caught across the 35, and he's down at the 32-yard line. A gain of 13 on the pass play. Another first down.
Yeah, that was the biggest play they had so far, and the man was wide open in a void out there in down the middle of the field. And so far defensively, we're not breaking, but we're bending a little here.
All right, now it's first and 10 for Argyle at the Carthage 32. Ani in the gun once again. Snap back to him. He's looking right. Now he's being pressured by Hart. Rolls to his right. Now he's going to run with it. 30, 25, and steps out of bounds at about the 24-yard line. That's going to be a gain of 8.
And that's what Larry said on the way up here, that he didn't run much this year, but tonight, Carthage thought he was going to run a lot more than he is. When you got a running quarterback, this is hard. Gilmer's ahead of Van Alstine 7-0, and Henderson's ahead 28-0.
Second and two for Argyle at the Carthage 24. Second and two at the Bulldog 24-yard line. Snap back to Ani. Ani hands off to Eveleth. Eveleth coming left, and he stopped after a gain of about one. Another hard hit on him there. That one by Tasker Shannon. Gain of one. It's going to bring up third down and one.
You keep putting the hat on them like that, they'll get tired of running through there. We've had some big hits already early in this game. With 8:18 left in the first period, 0-0.
All right, let's see. Do we have access to Dustin down there?
We'll try.
Don't know, huh? Okay, Dustin, I tell you what. We will go down to you after this next play. You'll need to make it pretty quick because Argyle is going without a huddle most of the time. Okay, third and one for Argyle at the Carthage 23. No wideouts. Handoff goes to the running back. Running back gets loose from one tackler, then is pushed back, but he will have a first down at the 21-yard line. Okay, Dustin, let's go down to you.
Right. Well,
okay. Well,
I tell you, there is some hitting going on down there. I wish we could get Dustin because there is some popping down there.
It is a gain of two. We'll spot it at the 21-yard line. Argyle, first and 10. They've picked up four first downs on this drive after forcing Carthage to punt. Carthage went three and out, a punt. Argyle, four first downs. They have it first and 10 at the Bulldog 21. Ani in the gun. Snap back to him. Looking right. Throws, and this one is incomplete. A low throw, and he is now two of four for 17 yards.
Yeah, and he might have had to get rid of that, and pressure might have made him do that. Ball was low, skipped up to the receiver. But now that's what we needed, a second long.
Second down and 10 for Argyle. Second and 10, the ball at the 21-yard line. Ani again in the shotgun with two receivers to the right, two to the left. Eveleth, the running back, with him in the backfield. Snap back to Ani. Ani looking left. Throws over the middle. This one is incomplete. And that'll bring up third down and 10 at the 21-yard line.
And Pope put a hit on the receiver, and he's slow to get up. We're hitting him out there, I can tell you that. And there was a lot of red in the area when he threw that ball. So third and long now. Here's 7:19 left, first quarter, 0-0.
Third down and 10. Big play here for the Carthage defense. Third down and 10, and let's see, we have a flag back at the 5-yard line.
Now that was thrown from the guy in the back. This young man was hurt, got up and walking, and got back down.
So that unsportsmanlike against Argyle. Unsportsmanlike penalty against Argyle. Okay, tell us what you saw, Mark.
Well, he was hurt. Pope hit him, And apparently he said something to Pope when he come by him, and the umpire heard it.
Well, there was a coach said something over there, too.
Okay. All right.
In fact, when the coach stepped out on the field and said something is when the flag went up.
Okay. Well, it looked like they had a legal formation, which means they were on our line of scrimmage, too. That bow was not.
Okay, now third and 25. That's a big 15-yarder there against Argyle, and that was a dead ball foul, so it came after the play. Third and 25 for Argyle at the Carthage 35. Snap back to Oni. Oni looking left, looking left. He throws over the middle. This is caught at the 15-yard line, and he's going to be shy of the first down. At the ball is out, and it is going to be, let's see what's going to happen here.
They're going
to
rule him down.
I think they're going to rule him down at about the 12.
So now it's fourth and short. Let's see what they'll do here. That was a real good play on their part.
Okay, 23-yard pass. And with it being fourth down and two, evidently Argyle's going to go for a field goal here. They bring Cole Hedlund in. They bring Hedlund in, and they're going to spot it at the 19-yard line.
They watch for a fake here.
19-yard line is where Argyle's going to spot it. This will be a 29-yard attempt, an angle back to the left. Wind behind him. High snap. He gets it down. The kick is away, and this one is good. Argyle with a 29-yard field goal. They take a 3-0 lead, 6:24 to play in the first. We'll be back right after this.
This is Steve Onford from Farmer State Bank. If you've been thinking about buying a new house, property, car, boat, or maybe even something else, now is the time. Loan interest rates are at an all-time low. Come in and talk to a Farmer State Bank loan officer today. We cannot wait for you to join our family. Farmers is an FDIC member and equal housing lender.
Reliable Healthcare in Carthage offers medical equipment and medical supplies. Wheelchairs, hospital beds, canes, walkers, incontinence supplies. They have it all. Call 903-694-2285. Reliable Healthcare is approved by Medicare and Medicaid. They also accept private insurance payments. Professional answers to all your medical questions. Your complete source of medical equipment and supplies is Reliable Healthcare. And now they have scrubs for your professional look. Reliable Healthcare in Carthage.
All right, we're back at Newsom Stadium in Mansfield as the Carthage Bulldogs will receive the kickoff. If you've just joined us, Carthage won the toss, three plays and out, and we had to punt a 32-yard kick, and Argyle took it and scored on a 29-yard field goal, and they lead it now 3-0, 6:24 to play in the first quarter. All right, Hedlund getting ready to kick off once again. Excuse me, this is not Hedlund kicking off. This is their punter kicking off, and it is a pooch kick. We take it at the 24, up to the 25, 30. This is Villanueva across the 35 and out to about the 39-yard line. Pretty good field position once again for the Bulldogs at our 39.
Cannot argue with that. Both of his kick returns have been pretty good, put us in good position. And so I consider that a victory a while ago. We're not letting him in the end zone, Larry. Give him just 3 points.
All right, so here come the Dogs out on the field. The first time we had two incomplete passes and a five-yard run by Tevin Pipkin, and we were forced to kick it and had a 32-yard kick, no return, and then Argyle took it down and scored on a field goal. All right, here's pitch out Pipkin. Pipkin going left, and he is going to be dropped at the 40-yard line, a one-yard gain, and that's it.
Yeah, they had a good linebacker play there. Linebacker shot through there in our blocking and made the tackle for a short gain. We had everybody else out there. We had a lot of guys out there pulling, but he slipped through the blocks. 5:59 left, 3-0 in favor of Argyle.
Okay, Dustin, we're going to try you again after this next play. Second and 9 for the Bulldogs at our own 40. Going into the win here in the first quarter. Ball on the left hash. Bogan shoots, three-step drop. He throws to the right. This is caught by Shannon at midfield, and he's across midfield and stopped at the 46-yard line of Argyle, first and 10.
And, boy, he adds a lot to our offense since we did early in the year. We had a lot of drop balls, including he had dropped a few balls, but I understand he got some new glasses and or contacts and now can see, and that's why he's catching the ball better.
All right, Dustin, we'll try you after this next one, after this next play. All right, first and 10 for the Dogs. Ball at the right hash.
Eye formation, handoff goes to Pipkin. Pipkin up the middle and drop for a one-yard loss. Okay, Dustin, down to you.
He just wanted to come up here and do his report.
Yeah, Dustin, I apologize. We did everything we could, but it's just not coming through, even though we've moved the antennas outside.
All right, second and 10 for the Bulldogs. Second and 10 at the Argyle 46-yard line. So far, they've done a pretty good job on Pipkin. After that first five-yard run, he's had a one-yarder and then no gains. All right, offset out of the right this time, second and 10. Here's a play-action fake. Bogenschutz going to throw it. Pretty good protection. Now he's going to run with it. Going to go up the middle across the 45 and stopped at about the 43, a gain of 2 yards.
Yeah, he didn't have anybody to throw to. It looked like there was good coverage down there and had to pull it down. He looked at his first read and his second read, and there wasn't anything there. So now we're down to third down. 4:28 left first quarter. We trail 3-0.
Third and seven for Carthage at the Argyle 43. 4:20 to go in the first quarter with Argyle leading 3-0. If you've just joined us, Henderson, we've got the latest score there. The latest one we had was 28-0 over Salina. That game started at 6 o'clock. All right, Bogenschutz this time is in the gun. And we've got twins to the right, to the left and one to the right, and we have a delay of game against Carthage.
Well, we just looked like we didn't know what we were doing. Nobody was lined up in the right spot. Coaches were waving, and so that'll be a little bit of a mark off there.
5-yard penalty moves it back to the Argyle 48. Dogs have not looked effective so far on offense. First series, three plays, and then a punt. We did pick up a first down on this series, but now we have it third down and 12. Third and 12 after that 5-yard penalty, and we have it at the Argyle 48-yard line. Need a big play here to keep the football. Need an offensive spark. Okay, Bogan shoots in the gun. Snap back to him. Here comes pressure, and he's going to be sacked. Pressure coming from a linebacker from the near side, and he is sacked for a loss, and it goes back to the 40-yard line.
Well, we have to punt now. He came through from the linebacker position unblocked. Somebody missed an assignment there of some kind. So we'll have to get the defense back on the field and let them start whipping. And that's what we need.
All right, the line of scrimmage is going to be the Carthage 45-yard line. And Jimmy Gonzalez comes in to kick for the second time tonight. 32-yard punt on the rugby kick, his first effort. And he stands back to take it after this 13-yard drop. A low snap once again. He picks it up. And this one is a high kick, and it's going to hit out of bounds. Let's see. The referee's going to have to spot it as he marches up the field. And it's going to be spotted at the 32-yard line. That will be a 22-yard kick.
Whatever, that wasn't a rugby-style kick that time. Destin's coming in a little now.
I heard him, yeah. Where are you?
2:48 left, 3-0 Argyle.
All right, 23-yard kick that time. Okay, Destin, we'll try it again after this next play and see if we can pick you up. 2:48 to go in the first quarter. Argyle leading 3-0. This will be their second possession. First time they picked up four first downs on their way to a field goal. First and 10 at their 32. Snap back to Awney. Awney hands off to Eveleth. Eveleth for about a couple of yards. Okay, Dustin, let's try it again.
Just not going to happen, guys. Whoop, there he is.
He's in and out.
Yep.
He may have to walk up in the stands a little bit and give a report and then go back down.
All right. We may have to invite him up here to the booth.
All right, it's now second down and 8 after that 2-yard gain. They have it at their 34. Second and 8 for Argyle at their own 34. Ball on the left hash. Snap back to Awney in the gun. Awney looking over the middle, still looking. Pretty good protection. Now he throws, and this one is picked off by the Bulldogs. It's picked off over there. It was tipped by the intended receiver and picked off by Dominic Collins.
Yeah, good play. Tipped, and that was good. Being in the area is what we need. He was in the area. When those tip balls happen, that's when the interceptions mostly happen. Now, that's the first break of the game. Let's see if we can take advantage of it here.
It was tipped and then picked off by Dominic Collins, and he was brought down at the Argyle 36.
He was overthrown, is what it was, and the young man went up to try to get it, and it flicked off his hand right into our man.
So for Awney, that is his sixth interception of the year, and the Bulldogs have got to take advantage of this. First and 10 now at the Eagle 36-yard line. Well, let's get a lead on him and see if we can put some more pressure on him. Here's Bogan shoots under center. He's going to go deep up to Pope. Pope has it at the 10, inside the 10, out of bounds at the 5-yard line. Oh, what a great pass that time. What a touch on it by Bogan shoots.
Yeah, throw it into the wind, too, at that point. And it did kind of go to the outside shoulder of Pope, but he, being a good athlete, could turn and look. But a great pitching catch there. Now, let's get into the end zone.
31-yard completion from Bogan shoots to Pope down to the Eagle 5-yard line. First and goal, Carthage at the Argyle 5. 2:02 to play in the first quarter. And Bogan shoots now will go under center. And we've got the jumbo package in there. Trent Jackson is the tailback. Here's a handoff to Jackson. Jackson over the left side, down to the 1-yard line, inside the 1. He's just shy of the goal line. It's going to be a 4-yard gain for Jackson, second and goal from about a foot away.
And we get down in here, we go to those big fellas. We get Bankhead in the game, and we get McCain in the backfield as a lead blocker. And Klassen's in there as a fullback. And we run Jackson.
Okay, here's the quarterback sneak, I believe, by Bogan shoots. Bogan shoots close to the goal line. No signal yet by the officials. Touchdown! Touchdown, Bulldogs. Bogan shoots on a 1-yard quarterback sneak, and the Bulldogs take a 6-3 lead.
Well, breaks will kill you, and we've got a break in this game and took advantage of it. You got to take advantage of the break when you get it, and we did. We're lining up in the swinging gate.
All right, dogs in the gate. And we got a flag. Flag over on the far side of the field.
False start us from on that side, Judge.
And this is a false start against Carthage. That'll move it back 5 yards.
And plus that makes a coach irritated because we were in that swinging gate. We were probably just going to move over here and kick it. And there's no reason to jump.
We had people coming on the field. We had players coming on the field before that flag was thrown, as that flag was thrown.
And it moves it back 5 yards on an extra point that's going into the wind. All right, let's see what we can do here on the extra point. It's going to be spotted now at the 15-yard line into the wind. Good high snap. He gets it down, kick is away, and it is good. Nice kick, Jimmy Gonzalez. Very good kick into the wind. And it's 7-3 dogs, 1:35 to play in the first quarter, back right after this.
At Devon Energy, we believe that to be a good company, we must first be a good neighbor. Our commitment runs deep in our relationships with the people of East Texas. Our employees are neighbors, mentors, leaders, and community volunteers. In Panola County, Devon Energy is a proud supporter of all area schools. Devon Energy Corporation, Carthage.
Hi, this is Steve Langford from Farmer State Bank. If you've been thinking about buying a new house, property, car, boat, or maybe even something else, now is the time. Loan interest rates are at an all-time low. Come in and talk to a Farmer State Bank loan officer today. We cannot wait for you to join our family. Farmers is an FDIC member and equal housing lender.
All right, we're back at Newsom Stadium in Mansfield. The Carthage Bulldogs taking advantage of a turnover, an interception by Dominic Collins on a tipped pass, and the Bulldogs score on a 1-yard quarterback sneak by Blake Bogan shoots. All right, Gonzalez ready to kick off. Dogs look like they might have something planned here.
They always have something planned, whether they use it or not, but they've always got something planned.
All right, we had a couple of guys over. Here's the kick, a sky kick by Gonzalez. Fair catch call for, and they make it at the 25-yard line. Boy, we'll take that every time. 25-yard line, they've got to go 75 yards, no return. And nice kick there by Gonzalez as the young man took it about a yard from the sideline, then went out of bounds. They're going to spot it at the 26.
They had a powwow down here on the defense earlier with Eric Robinson and them lining out what the problems they might have had in that first drive.
All right, the defense out on the field now for the Bulldogs. Oney's going to be in the gun once again, as he has been the entire ball game. Eveleth, the running back, with him in the backfield. Wide out to the right, goes motion left. Handoff to Eveleth. Eveleth trying the right side and picks up 5 yards. That's one of his best gains of the night out to the 30-yard line.
Yeah, and we had guys all around the area. I don't know how he squirted through there, but he did. Got a minute 22 left in the first quarter. 7-3 Carthage. Need our defense to stand up right here.
All right, gain of four after they spot it. They spot it at the 30, gain of four from the 26 to the 30. Second and six for Argyle at their 30. Snap back to Ani. Ani looking left, he throws. It's caught at the 35-yard line, and he's down at the 39 for a first down, a pickup of nine on the play.
Yeah, and then he got hit hard by Jackson, and he's, again, slow to get up. We've been hitting that number three. Every time he gets it, we're punishing him, and you can tell it. He's in the huddle now, bent over.
He was a young man that was hit hard by Pope on the play where Argyle picked up the unsportsmanlike conduct penalty on their scoring drive where they picked up the field goal. Okay, it's now first and 10 for Argyle. They have it at their 39-yard line. Here's Oni throwing to the right, incomplete, off the hands of the intended receiver. Second down and 10.
Yeah, he had a guy was lined up in the slot and kind of did a wave out to the right side, and he hit a lead blocker that was in front of him. He'd have caught it. He might have had some yardage there. We run that play quite a bit ourselves.
So it is now third down. Second and 10 for Argyle at their 39. Okay, Dustin, we'll try you again after this next play. Oni in the gun. Snap back to him. Hand off to Eveleth going to his right. Running room, 45. And midfield has a first down, a gain of 11. Okay, Dustin, let's try it again.
Well, okay. We'll just have to let him.
Dustin, first, bring your microphone back up to the press box, and let's change frequencies and see if that helps.
First down and 10 for Argyle after the 11-yard pickup by Eveleth. First and 10 for Argyle at midfield. Snap back to Oni. Oni, play action fake. Throws over the middle. S is caught, and it's caught at the 35, and he's down to the 41-yard. Backed up by the Bulldogs. Tasker Shannon has it. As we stripped him, Shannon returns it to the 39-yard line. We have it after the fumble by Argyle.
He just took it away from him, was making the tackle, and just jerked it out of there, and he had the ball. So we get another break. We'll take him.
Second turnover by the Argyle Eagles. The first one was an interception by Dominic Collins, and that one, okay, describe that again. We had two or three guys there, and one of them just stripped it away. Was it Shannon who did it?
Shannon was the first one there. I mean, another guy showed up, but at the time he was wrestling with the ball and then just jerked it out.
All right, first and 10 for the Bulldogs. It's spotted at the 38, so two turnovers in the ball game, both against the Eagles. All right, Bogan shoots under center. Handoff goes Pipkin. Pipkin left side. He breaks it 45 and midfield. And that's going to be a first down for the Bulldogs by far. Pipkin's best run of the night. It's a 12-yarder.
And if we get a production out of him tonight, then it's going to take the pressure off of Bogan Shoots, and he can manage the game and throw to those seven receivers like he threw to last week. Both teams rely on the run.
And that's the end of the first quarter. Carthage up 7-3. We'll be back from Mansfield right after this from KGAS.
Reliable Healthcare in Carthage offers medical equipment and medical supplies. Wheelchairs, hospital beds, canes, walkers, incontinence supplies. They have it all. Call 903-694-2285. Reliable Healthcare is approved by Medicare and Medicaid. They also accept private insurance payments. Professional answers to all your medical questions. Your complete source of medical equipment and supplies is Reliable Healthcare. And now they have scrubs for your professional look. Reliable Healthcare in Carthage.
If you're thinking about working on your own car, whether you're replacing your brakes, changing the oil, or even just replacing the wiper blades, you need to head to Toledo Automotive in Carthage. Toledo Automotive always has the parts you need when you need it, no matter what the job is. And if they don't, they'll get it for you. Toledo Automotive in Carthage is also your authorized distributor of Mack Truck parts in the Carthage area. When something goes wrong, check with the friendly, knowledgeable staff at Toledo Automotive, your NAPA dealer in Carthage. 903-693-7806.
All right, Bulldogs first and 10 now at midfield. First and 10 at midfield. Offset out of the right. Here is a handoff to Cage. Now back to Bogan Shoots. Bogan Shoots wants to go deep. He wants to go deep to Pope down at the goal line. It is called. Great catch, Ed Pope. What a play.
Let me describe it to you.
Catch by Ed Pope. A 50-yard touchdown pass to Ed Pope.
He threw
it
well,
a special play, and Pope with a spectacular grab.
He threw the ball to Cage, which was a lateral. He threw it back to Bogan Shoots out in the left flat, which was still behind the line of scrimmage, and he just heaved a bomb, and Pope was falling backwards when the ball had hit him right in the chest, and they landed on top of him, but touchdown, Dogs.
All right, we have Cage Lake coming in on the field for the extra point, and the referee calling timeout now.
See what
and is that going to be a flag against Carthage?
What's that mean?
I'm not for sure.
Okay.
All right, 11:49 to play in the first half. The Bulldogs scoring on a 50-yard touchdown pass. Bogan shoots to Ed Pope on a spectacular grab. Gonzalez now with the win to attempt the extra point. Good snap. The kick is away. It looks good. It's right down the middle. It's good. Carthage up 14-3. With 11:49 to play in the first half, back from Mansfield right after this.
The ladies at the Popcorn Place invite you to get happy this Christmas season. Get happy by checking out their all-new Get Happy collections. Each Friday from now until Christmas, the Popcorn Place will offer a Friday special day sale. Don't forget the big Christmas open house, December the 2nd at the Popcorn Place. Check them out on their Facebook. What a great place to shop, the Popcorn Place in Carthage.
Make stopping at the fill-in station one of your daily routines. Stop in before school or work for some delicious breakfast burritos, biscuits with egg and sausage, and fresh-made breakfast toasters. They always have those wonderful Crispitos, and while you're there, pick up lunch items. The deli has corn dogs, fried chicken, pizza sticks, chicken tenders, potato logs, as well as barbecue sandwiches and chicken sandwiches. Not to mention Bluebell ice cream and cold drinks. The fill-in station on West Sabine, locally owned by Bill and Donna Arnold. Hope to see you soon.
All right, I did not do a great job of calling that. I tell you what, it really helps when I go out to practice and see these special plays practiced before they are shown in the ball game. So we'll describe that one to you right after this kickoff, because it involved three passes there. Two of them were backward passes or laterals. And Gonzalez here ready to kick off. The Dogs up 14-3. Here's a sky kick that's going to come to the near sideline. But a return this time. They take it at the 15. Going left now to the 20. Fumble ball on the ground. We've got it, I think. A big scramble for it down at the 17-yard line. We may have it. And we do. Carthage with another turnover against Argyle. A hard hit at the 20-yard line. We've got it now at the 17.
And I don't know if somebody again jerked it out or not, but there was two or three Bulldogs there on the tackle. And all of a sudden the ball just popped straight up over a helmet, and then of course Chore, looked like it was Chore there, and he got it.
And okay, let's describe the touchdown play. It was a pass to first of all to Clint Cage, a backward pass,
who
a lateral
rolled to the middle of the field,
then threw back to Bogenschutz,
who rolled for the side,
rolled to the side, and then he threw it downfield. Now it didn't work the way it's supposed to, because it's supposed to be a trick, a surprise play, and Pope is to be wide open, but he was not wide open at all. There were two men there, correct? That
right.
He took it away from. Unbelievable grab by Ed Pope, best of the year. Hand off Pipkin. Pipkin left side across the 15, stopped at about the 12 for about a 5-yard gain.
And you see, you know, last year we played them, and this team's bad about hitting late and right at the last second, and right then, number 17 on their team, Tevin was already on the ground, and he rolled over him and kicked him in the head when he rolled over him. They're dirty. I hope we put it all over them.
All right, Bogan shoots under center. We've got a man split out to each side. Pipkin, the tailback, takes a 8-yard drop. Bogan shoots under center. Here's the handoff, goes to Pipkin. Pipkin up, tries to go up the middle and gets loose. Pipkin, a great run inside the 10 down to about the 6-yard line. He would not be denied. He got away from a big linebacker in the backfield, and he picks up 6. It'll be first and goal.
And here comes the jumbo packaging, but Larry's right. He looked like he was stopped dead to right, kept his feet churning. All of a sudden, he shot out of there and ended up getting tackled by a defensive back after a good 7 or 8-yard gain. Good thrust by the Dogs. Now we bring in the big package.
Jumbo package in. Dawes got to take advantage of this third Argyle turnover. Bogan shoots under center. Bogan shoots. Hand off Jackson. Jackson up the middle. Jackson toward the goal line. Touchdown, Dogs. 6-yard run. Trent Jackson. The Dogs are up 20-3.
I tell you what I'd do, Larry. If I got 21-point lead like almost we got now, I'd take that jumbo package and run the rest of the game. They can't stop it. And Jackson's run just like Tevin. When he gets hit, he doesn't slow down.
All right, Dogs up 20-3 here, 10:36 to play in the second quarter. They line up in the swinging gate again. And with the win, Jimmy Gonzalez to attempt the extra point. We await the snap. There's the snap. The kick is away, right down the middle again. Beautiful extra point by Gonzalez. It's 21-3 Dogs, 10:36 to play until halftime. Back from Mansfield right after this.
Are you tired of being just another policy number? Call Tate Barber at State Farm, where we still believe in the old version of the golden rule. Treat others as you want to be treated. If trustworthy service is as important to you as it is to him, then go by today. They don't want to just write your insurance. They want to take the time to customize a policy to fit your individual insurance needs and become your agent and friend for life. Call Tate Barber today at State Farm, 903-693-7555.
All right, we're back at Mansfield's Newsom Stadium. The Bulldogs taking advantage of another turnover by the Argyle Eagles. This one on the kickoff. We recovered at their 17-yard line, and they score. The Bulldogs do on a 6-yard run by Trent Jackson.
That jumbo package is just worth its weight in gold when you get short yarded situation. We'll also use that on, you know, 3rd and 1 or 4th and 1 or something like that. Gonzalez, and while, by the way, that throw by Bogenschutz, that wouldn't have worked in the wind. You know, he had the wind behind him. That ball looked like it was going to be short at one time. It ended up being a pretty decent pass at the end.
And again, what a catch by Ed Pope. I tell you, that the most spectacular, in my opinion, grab of the year. Now, Coach Surratt would argue that there was another one earlier that was as good or better than that. Here's a sky kick, and they're going to return it this time from the 16, the 20, 25, and stopped at the 28-yard line. And the Bulldogs pin them down there at the 28. It'll be 1st and 10 Eagles at their own 28, 10:31 to play in the first half. Carthage up 21-3.
Bri Bolton had to hit on that. He hit him hard, too. We're sticking our helmets on these boys.
17, who returned it, is walking gingerly off the field. And, you know, that was one of the things that Coach Surratt said. This team is known for being very physical. Some would say dirty. And we have to match them in physicality. And so far, I think we're doing that. Okay, Ani in the gun. They are very dangerous offensively. Here's Ani, play action fake. He's going to throw over the middle. He's got it at the 40, 45, midfield. And the helmet comes off, and he stopped at the Carthage 48-yard line. Big gain on that play.
That boy is catching good balls. I got number 3 for them. But, boy, when he's getting it, they're punishing him. This time his helmet came flying off of that, out of the tackle. So we are putting a hat on him. But that quarterback to that number 3, what's his name, Larry? He's really good. That's a good pitch and catch combination.
All right, 1st and 10 for Argyle now at the Bulldog 48-yard line. And that is Chad Bossell. Bossell. It was the receiver that time. Bossell also runs it for him some. Has not run it so far tonight. Here's Ani. Ani looking left. Now he's being chased out of the pocket by Adams. Now he goes back to the right. And he's going to run with the football. He's to the 45, and he goes down. He does not want to be hit that time, and he goes down after a 5-yard gain. He didn't want to take a hit, and he went down for a 5-yard pickup.
And the same thing happened on the other side of the field earlier in the game when I told you he stepped out of bounds with about 3 yards left when he had just ducked his shoulder, might have had a 1st down. Now, maybe the coaches are telling him not to take a hit, and that could very well be true.
That could be true. All right, 2nd down and 5 for Argyle. 2nd and 5 for the Eagles at the Dogs' 43-yard line. 2nd and 5 for Argyle at the Carthage 43. Carthage up 21-3 here in the second quarter. Ani now appears to be changing the play at the line of scrimmage. Down to 5 seconds on the play clock, 4-3. They're going to have to call a timeout, and they do. Timeout at Mansfield. We'll take a break right after this. We'll be back with Bulldog football.
HEB is your hometown and neighborhood grocery store where you'll always find friendly faces, affordable prices, and quality products. HEB in Carthage has the finest produce and meat combined with trustworthy brands to keep your grocery bill low. Why waste your time and gas going out of town when your local HEB has everything that you need at prices that you'll love? HEB in Carthage. Here, everything is better.
Courtney Construction of Carthage knows the oil field and pipeline business. Courtney Construction provides equipment and labor for pipeline jobs, facility installations and repairs, compressor installations, pit closures and reclamations. Courtney Construction can provide the equipment, personnel, and resources required to install up to 24-inch pipe. Courtney Construction has the labor, the equipment, and the know-how. So call 903-694-2911. Courtney Construction, Highway 79 North in Carthage.
All right, second and five for Argyle after the timeout. They now have two left. We have three timeouts remaining. Second and five for the Eagles at the Dogs' 43-yard line. Dustin, we'll try to go down to you after this next play. Hopefully we've got our problems worked out. Okay, Oney in the gun. Snap back to him, looking left. Now he's being forced out of the pocket. He's going to run with it to the 40, 35, and he goes down again to avoid a hit at the 35-yard line. That's going to be a gain of 8 yards. Okay, Dustin, down to you.
It's not going to happen.
There's a whole lot of interference in the stadium. They have their wireless next door to us. The radio station has theirs. Their wireless mic, by the way, Larry, is not working either, I found out.
Okay. Not the night for wireless mics. Oh.
We need the walkie-talkies going again.
First and 10 for Argyle now at the Dog 35. Trips to the right. Here's play action fake. Oney being forced out of the pocket. He rolls to the right. He throws. It's complete, and he steps out of bounds. The intended receiver does. The receiver does at the 31-yard line after a gain of 4.
Now, I'll tell you what he's doing. If y'all watched Cowboys play, he'll fake like he's going to hand it off and then just stand there for a second like he's going to throw a pass, and then he'll take off running. And Romo does that a lot. They act like they're going to pass it, and then they'll hand it to it late. So,
all right, Oney is going to be in the gun once again. This time he has three receivers to the left and one to the right. Snap back to Oney. He's rolling to his left. He wants to throw left, throws left. It's called at the 27, 25, down to the 20-yard line. That's going to be a first down. That will be a gain on the play of about 11 yards.
You know, and it's lucky right now that they spotted us 21-3, because if we get into a scoring match, at least we've got the advantage from here on out if we score as much as they score.
All right, it's now first and 10. Our guy with a very good-looking drive this time. First and 10 at the Dog 20-yard line. Snap back to Oney. Oney hands off to Eveleth, going back to his left. Now he cuts up the middle. Hard hit there in the middle. I think that was, number 44. That was Justin Williams, I believe.
No,
and
Jackson.
That was Jackson, okay, on the big hit. 2-yard gain for Eveleth.
That was number 20, running into number 20, and our number 21, that, I can tell you, he knocked him straight backwards. He will stick his nose in there. That boy will hit you.
Second down and 8 now. Second and 8 for Argyle. 7:58 to play in the half. Carthage leading 21-3. Argyle has it second and 8 at the Dog 18-yard line. Argyle with a good drive going right now. Snap back to Oney. Oney looking over the middle. Good protection wide this open time. He throws, and it's incomplete. What a big hit by the Bulldogs. That was Michi Bowman on the intended receiver, Ian Sandler, just a sophomore, and it's an incomplete pass.
And he had a man wide open down there. Don't you think the coaches didn't see that? He was wide open in the left end zone down there. Of course, we might have reacted and pulled off of him at the last second when that ball was thrown out there. But Bulldogs are really hitting out there. I can tell you, Michi hit him and dislodged. That's two passes that we've dislodged just by our hits.
Third and eight for Argyle at the Dog 18-yard line. Big play here. Snap back to Oney in the gun. Oney looking right, throws into the end zone. Flag's going to come down. This could be interference against Carthage.
Yeah, it looks like it may be, because it was right there, unless the young man pushed off. But he's looking for a number to talk. That's inside the 5 is where that is.
And so, I remember if it were in the pros, it'd be spotted down inside the 5. It's a spot foul there, but it's not in high school football.
It's a half the distance now, isn't it?
It will be. It'll be a 15-yard penalty, so it's going to be half the distance. Should go from the 18 down to the 9. It should be at the 9-yard line.
All right, they've got a long way to go.
That's right.
That's about as far as you can.
Whoa, okay. My mistake. Going to be down at the 3.
Maybe.
Okay, so it is a 15-yard penalty as it works out from the 18 down to the 3. And it'll be first and goal for Argyle. First and goal for Argyle at the Carthage 3-yard line. 7:37 to play in the first half. Carthage leading 21-3. First and goal for Argyle at our 3-yard line. All right, Awney this time is going to go under center. He's got three running backs with him in the backfield. Double tight end formation. Awney hands off to the running back. She tries to go up the middle, and he's pushed back after a gain maybe of one. Maybe he got
another
one.
Flag.
No, I don't think he did. Okay, a flag down.
There's another one. Oh, boy. That's unsportsmanlike on more than one, looks like. Let's see what they say. And there was also a flag on the sidelines over there, Larry. Looks like somebody was offsides. But it happened in the defensive backfield. One of the big linemen for them was downfield. And that's where the flag was thrown. And then another flag came flying in. So what they do here, got three flags on one play.
All right, let's see if we can pick up the referee. Have we got that ability, Jerry?
Thought we did.
Offside Carthage. Dead ball. Oh, offside Carthage. Offsetting dead ball fouls against both teams. So it's going to be a penalty against Carthage. Offsetting unsportsmanlike conduct penalties against both teams. Those offset. So the penalty goes 1.5 yards down to the 1.5.
Dexter Clow comes in and spares McCain. And McCain is getting a casual conversation from the coach down there. So I feel like he might have been the culprit. Matter of fact, it looked like they did it first, and then we retaliated and got another penalty after. That's what it looked like to me.
And had it not been for that, they'd be pushed back 15 yards. Okay, here's Awney under center. Awney, play action fake. He wants to throw it. Now he's being pressured. He throws it away. Throws it away in the end zone. He wanted to throw it and got pressure, and we hemmed him inside. He could not go to the outside, and he just throws it out of the end zone.
Now, sometimes I don't understand that call because they have a jumbo package just like we do, and they try a pass on first down, which could be easily intercepted or sacked.
All right, second down now. Second and goal for Argyle. Second and goal from our 1.5. Awney under center, three backs with him in the backfield, and here's the handoff. It goes to Rossell. Rossell's into the end zone for the touchdown. So Argyle gets a touchdown. It's 21-9 now. Carthage up 21-9, 7:09 to play in the first half, and we await the extra point here in Mansfield.
Yeah, and we've got 7 minutes left, plenty of time to take the offense and take a good drive down the field. And then, because they get the ball to start the second half.
Yes, they do. Chad Bossell with the run, the 1-yard run. Low snap, and the kick is away, and it is good. It is 21-10. Carthage up, 7:09 to play in the first half. Back from Mansfield right after this.
At First State Bank and Trust Company, we understand how important a dependable, independent bank is to growing families, farms, and businesses. That's the reason you'll find a level of respect and customer service here that is uncommon today. If that sounds like the kind of strong, can-do bank you're looking for, come let us show you more. A lot more. First State Bank and Trust Company, Carthage. Deep in the heart of Panola County.
Since 1951, Pippin Motor Company has been serving you, the residents of Panola and surrounding counties. Hi, I'm Will Blackwell, and I want to personally invite you to buy your next newer pre-owned vehicle from us. Quality GM products, top dollar for trade-ins, low interest rates, large rebates, and a no-pressure sales experience. What better place to buy your next new or pre-owned vehicle? That's Pippin Motor Company across from Panola College, 693-6691, or on the web at pippinmotorcompany.com.
All right, Argyle has scored on a 1-yard run by Chad Bossell, and the extra point makes it now 21-10 Dogs. 7:09 left to play in the first half. Now, remember, Argyle will be kicking off into the wind.
I'll watch something tricky here.
Their kicker is Cole Headland, sophomore. And he is now, after that extra point, 60 of 62 in extra points this year, 16 of 18 in field goals. So both teams have a sophomore kicker. Headland ready to kick off. Dogs have a couple of guys back deep. One of them is Michi Bowman. And here is the kick. And this is sort of a pooch kick. And Shannon takes it at the 27 up to the 30.
35. Ball is fumbled, and they've got it. Argyle recovers after Tasker Shannon fumbled at the 35-yard line. Shannon fumbled, and Argyle gets it at our 32.
Yes, that's going to be a hurtful situation. With 7:02 left, we were needing that ball to run some time off the clock to maybe go score. And they spotted us a couple of touchdowns, and we don't need to give them back.
All right, first and 10, Argyle at the Carthage 32-yard line. First turnover against the Bulldogs. Well, let's see if the defense can stop them now. Awney in the shotgun. Here's the handoff to the running back. This is Eveleth coming to the right, and he's tackled. Nice tackle there by, let's see, that's going to be D.K. Callaway. Callaway with the stop, but it's going to be a 4-yard gain on the play.
Yeah, we had one more lineman in that time than we usually run. We had five down, and they tried to get to the outside, and they did so for 5 yards. That's Callaway's position to make that tackle if he's on the outside.
Okay, the gain goes to the 28, second down and 6. Gain of 4 on the play, second and 6. Ball on the right hash. Here's a snap back to Awney, play action fake. Awney wants to throw it, and he throws it. It's caught on the right side, and he is going to be stopped at the 21-yard line. They're going to give him forward progress at the 21, and that's going to be a first down.
First down for Argyle. Now you can see why they're 10-1. They have a pretty good diversified offense. They've run multiple situations off of these different plays that they've got. So, and their quarterback's seasoned.
Awney is in the gun this time. First and 10 at the Dog 21-yard line. And here's the handoff. It goes to Eveleth. Eveleth going left. He's the 15 and down close to the 11-yard line for what would be another first down. It's going to be a gain of 9 to the 12.
Yeah, and they got to the outside again. They're getting good blocks and cutting it. Our defensive guys are not cutting it in. So that's probably a passing down here, second and short.
Second down and 1 for Argyle. Second and 1 for Argyle at the Carthage 12-yard line. Awney in the gun, trying to take advantage of a Bulldog turnover. Snap back to Awney, hands off to Eveleth. Eveleth coming to the right, to the 10, and brought down at about the 9. That's going to be a gain on the play of 3 and a first down. It's going to be first and goal for Argyle from the Carthage 9.
That was a good play there by Michi Bowman. He was engaged with the blocker and shucked the blocker and made the tackle. So that was a good play by Michi on the outside, tackling by himself.
Whereas we had the momentum for sure after creating those turnovers and getting a 21-3 lead, the momentum now has shifted back to the Eagles. Bulldogs need a big play defensively. First and goal for Argyle at the Carthage 9-yard line, trailing 21-10. Here's Awney rolling to his left. He wants to throw it. Now here's some heavy pressure. Now he rolls back to the right. He's going to run with it. He is to the 5 and goes down at the 5-yard line again to avoid a big hit and picks up 4.
Yes, and you can tell he does not want to get hit, but that could be a wise decision by his coach for sure, because they may not have a decent backup. You know, you've noticed in the NFL, a bunch of quarterbacks went down. They've been struggling. Everybody's signing all kinds of guys that were recently cut.
And he is, I will say this, boy, he's a good scrambler. All right, let's see. This time they're going to be in the Wildcat. Snap back to a running back going left, and he is inside the 5 and stopped at about the 3. Awney, for the first time in the game, did not take the snap there in the Wildcat. It was taken by a wideout, and he picks up 2 yards.
And they've got a big play coming up right here. We need to stop them right here, make them kick the field goal.
That was Ian Sadler, a sophomore wideout, taking it. Is third and goal now. Third and goal for Argyle from the Carthage 3. And as Mark said, a very big play here. Would be a big boost for Carthage if we could hold them to 3. Third and goal for Argyle from the Carthage 3-yard line. Awney is back in there under center. 3 backs with him in the backfield, and we've got an early flag. Let's see. We jumped but got back, I thought. Maybe we made contact.
Well, if they flinch and we jump, we're okay.
But it's going to be against Argyle. All right, so false start against Argyle moves them back from the 3 to the 8.
Now they bring a whole new package in.
So now instead of having their jumbo package in where Awney goes under center and he has three running backs behind him in sort of a T formation.
Spreading this out.
Now he's going to go into the gun. He's got three receivers to the right, one to the left. Awney will take it in the gun. Third and goal from the eight. Snap back to Awney. Awney looking over the middle, being chased by Hart, rolling to his right, and he throws it away. Threw it away to avoid being sacked, and that will bring in the field goal team.
Yeah, okay, we'll call that a win on our defense.
Absolutely.
And they were put in a bad position and have come out, unless this is a fake where they get faked. But they got pretty good kickers. They're pretty trustworthy, I think.
Now, he will be kicking into the breeze that we have here, but we saw Jimmy Gonzalez nail an extra point from about this position. Okay, to be spotted at the 14, a 24-yard effort, slight angle back to the right. Slight angle to the right. Here is the kick, and it is away, and it is going to be good. And the score now is Carthage 21, Argyle 13, 3:20 to play in the half. We'll return to Mansfield right after this break.
Ken Turner Pharmacy on the Square in downtown Carthage has what you need to make you feel better. Not only will Ken Turner Pharmacy fill your prescription promptly, they'll also deliver it to your door. That way you can stay in bed and get better. Whether it's medication you need or a special gift from our gift shop that no one else will have, stop by Ken Turner Pharmacy. Ken Turner Pharmacy on the Square in Carthage, where Carthage's finest tradition.
Have you visited Carthage Furniture lately? Carthage Furniture is the huge store behind the car wash on West Panola. Monty Bacon and his fine staff offer you a large selection of Ashley and Lane recliners. With more than 40 in stock, you have a great selection of colors, styles, and sizes starting at $299. Monty suggests you sit in the all-new high-back, wing-back Lane recliner starting at just $299. For the big man, your recliner starting at only $599. Carthage Furniture, the huge store behind the car wash on West Panola.
All right, we're back at Mansfield's Newsome Stadium, 3:20 to play in the first half. Carthage up now 21-13. Argyle has scored the last 10 points of the ball game, 1 yard run by Chad Bossel, and the kick made it 21-10, 7:09 to play in the second quarter. On the ensuing kickoff, Tasker Shannon fumbled, and our defense holds and forces them to try a field goal, and they're good from 24 yards out. All right, here is the advance on the ball and the kick. And this is another pooch kick, and it's going to hit on the ground. Someone needs to cover it for the Bulldogs, and it goes out of bounds, luckily. Boy, we were late in getting there. The fella up in front of it decided not to retreat, and Michi Bowman was coming up, but it fortunately went out of bounds.
He gave up there. He gave up on it and went to block, and then didn't realize Michi was down around the goal line. And Richie was running fast as he could, but he couldn't get to it, and the ball just happened to hit right by the yard line and then go out. Lucky us. Now, we need to do something with the ball this time. We've got to go down there and score because they get the ball at the first to second half, and we need to be ahead by at least 10. Tatum's ahead 23-0 at half.
All right, so the Bulldogs will have the football first and 10 at the 30-yard line. .320 to go, as Mark said, here in the half. And the Bulldogs, let's see, the last time we scored was with 10:36 to go in the half on the 6-yard run by Trent Jackson. 10 unanswered points since then by Argyle. So they've regained some momentum. We need, but that was a big stop by our defense, forcing them into a field goal. Hand off Pipkin, left side running room, 35. And he's cut down at the 39-yard line. It looked like he might even get more. Nice tackle there by one of the Eagles, 9 yards for Pipkin.
Yeah, we got to the outside that time. They overloaded the left-hand side of the defense. It looks like they were rushing a linebacker from the left-hand side, their left, and we ran to our left, which that way we had plenty of running room to the outside. That's a good way. Now we got second and short. We can try some kind of a pass.
Second down and one. Bulldogs not yet in a big hurry. 2:47 to play in the half. We do have all three timeouts remaining. All right, one wide out to the right, two to the left. Wide out right goes motion left, And here's a play-action fake. Bogenschutz going to throw it to the near sideline. Incomplete over the head and over the wrong shoulder of Sammy Chore.
Okay, that's okay. We can now go up and run this ball and get a first down. And that does stop the clock. Give us a little bit more time to get a play in. And we're going to run the big jumbo package in there.
All right, so we consider it important enough to pick up the first down. As Mark said, we send in the jumbo package. That means Trent Jackson will be the tailback, and we send in Bankhead, Griffin Bankhead. And here's a quarterback sneak by Bogenschutz. And I believe he's got it, not by much, but he does have it.
Let's see.
I think.
Depends on what side they mark it on.
Yep.
The official says he
does. Okay. First and 10 for the Bulldogs. That does stop the clock. 2:29 to go. We have it first and 10 at our 40. Gargyle has scored the last 10 points. Bulldogs taking advantage of some turnovers that they created, took a 21-3 lead. Argyle has come back for a touchdown and a field goal to make it 21-13 right now. Bogan shoots under center. And here's a play-action fake. He wants to throw it. Heavy pressure. Here's a throw. Great. Caught by Cage at the 40. 45. Screen play. Midfield. 45. Now big gainer there for the Bulldogs as he is across into Argyle territory. That's going to be a gain of 18 yards to the Eagle 42.
That's a new wrinkle we have not seen. A screen pass to the tight end. And he got, I think, got out of bounds. They blew it dead. I know it was a first down, but he got out of bounds, which gives us time where they won't roll the clock.
All right, the replay shown on the big jumbotron here at Newsom Stadium. Bogenschutz up to the line of scrimmage. Bogenschutz under center, first and 10 at the Argyle 42. Wide out right goes motion left. That's Pope. Here's Bogenschutz. Play action fake. He wants to throw it. Heavy pressure. Another screen pass going left going right to Pope this time. And he has it across the 40. And he is also out of bounds at about the 37.
That's a new wrinkle, too. We haven't seen him coming in motion. And then they go to him on a quick pass, kind of a screen situation.
That's a gain of 4 on the pass play to Pope. Second and 6 now. Again, he went out of bounds. So we've got a couple of players here going out of bounds to preserve time. 2 minutes to go in the first half. Carthage leading 21-13. Second and 6 at the Eagle 38-yard line. Ball is on the right hash. Carthage going right to left here in the second quarter. Bogan shoots under center. And here's a handoff to Pipkin. Pipkin going left. Bounces off of one defender. Now he's going to try to go back to the right, cut off there, tried to go to the middle, cut off there, bottom line, didn't gain anything.
Yeah, I think he missed his hole on the first try, and then when he bounced to the outside, it was just pursuit. Every time he made a cut, there was a new guy there, so he might have got a yard, I don't know. 1:39 left, we have all of our timeouts left.
All right, pretty good spot for us there, and it is a 1 yard gain to the 37, so it's now third and five for Carthage at the 37-yard line, and timeout is called over on the far side by Argyle. That's correct. We'll take a break here at Mansfield. Back right after this.
For 28 years, Panola National Bank has been an active partner in our community, working in civic organizations, schools, and churches, helping Panola County and its citizens with their financial needs. Community banking is basic to America, and we're proud of our success. As the Bulldogs, Bearcats, Tigers, Yellow Jackets, and Mustangs realize goals with teamwork, we at Panola National Bank rely on our team members. We invite you to come in and meet them. As a reminder, we open a little earlier and stay a little later for your convenience. Member FDIC and an equal housing lender.
When you're looking for high quality personal care from people on whom you can depend, choose East Texas Medical Center.
Well, they fell up on the computer there.
Well,
a minute 25. 1:25 left in the half. 21-13 Carthage. We have the ball inside the 40.
Going to be at the 37-yard line. Bulldogs with still three timeouts remaining, and as Mark said, a minute 25, and so if you're at the Argyle 37, plenty of time, but the immediate concern here is the first down, third and five at the Eagle 37-yard line. We've got two receivers to the right and two to the left. Bogenschutz is going to be in the gun this time. Bogenschutz in the gun. Pipkin is with him in the backfield. Twins to each side. Snap back to Bogan Shoes. Here they come with a blitz. Going to go deep on the far side, and this is going to be incomplete, intended for Michi Bowman.
I don't think Michi even saw that. He looked like he wasn't even going for the ball. It looked like he was just looking for it. So a fourth down for the Dogs. Minute 19 left. Now, do we run the ball here? Make them take a timeout? If we don't, well, it'll change anyway. We want to change hands, so if we don't get a first down.
We lost almost a yard there in the spotting of the football. It was at the 37. Now it's at the 38. And the reason for that is that the marker over on the far side of the field never spotted it at the 37. But at any rate, it's fourth down. Fourth down and about six from where they spotted it. Bogan shoots in the gun. Fourth and six. Obviously a big play here. He throws left, and this one is incomplete. As slipping there was Ed Pope, or I think he would have come up with that.
Yeah, that was a good throw, and it was, he slipped, and there was no way he could get to it. But if he wouldn't have slipped, it would have been a perfect timing route, been a first down for Carthage. Now they have a minute 15 left.
Yes, they do. Minute 15 to go in the half, and Argyle now with the football at their 38-yard line. Remember, the Eagles will get the football to start the second half. And so, obviously, a stop is imperative here on this drive for Argyle. Now, remember, they've only got one timeout remaining. Snap back to Oni in the gun. Oni wants to throw it. Good protection this time. Now it's starting to break down, being chased by Graves, and he throws this one over the Carthage bench.
Yeah, we were only rushing three that time, Larry. We had eight in the defensive backfield, and that's why he had plenty of time. But then it did break down, and we did force him to throw it away.
All right, let's see what we're going to do on this one here. We're going to have, again, just three rushing. It's going to be Hart, Ware, and Graves. Hart, Ware, and Graves, so just three men on the defensive front for Carthage. Second down, Oni in the gun. Snap back to him. He's going to run with it now. He's to the 40 and cut down at the 40-yard line after only a two-yard pickup.
Good, good tackle by Michi Bowman in the open field.
Third down and eight. And I was just wondering if Coach Surratt would use a timeout. I'm sure he'll use one if they don't pick up the first down here. At least I think he would. Third down and eight. Here's a snap back to Oni. Oni rolling to his left. He wants to throw, and it's low and into the ground, incomplete. That'll stop the clock with 38 seconds to go.
And that'll be now fourth down, won't it?
Yes.
Fourth down, so we'll get the ball back with 38 seconds. But I believe we just, of course, you can't tell what he's going to do. Anyway, so he may have a trick play up his sleeve.
All right, we're going to drop back Pope and Bowman, and this will be the first punt for Argyle. First punt for Argyle, and their punter, Anthony Fuquay, takes a 14-yard drop. Line of scrimmage is the 40. 14-yard drop, waist-high snap. We are very cautious. Make sure he's going to kick it. He does, and it's going to hit at the 24, taken by Bowman at the 20. And let's see, he is spun around and finally dropped at the 23-yard line. What you're scared of there is they've got two guys on him, and all of a sudden someone might come in and strip it away. But they do not. Carthage has it at our 23. Going to be interesting to see what Surratt does with 25 seconds left.
Well, you know, manage the game, right? Your quarterback so far has managed the game pretty well. I don't think you do anything spectacular here. I think you take your lead and go in at halftime and then make our adjustments like we do on defense in the second half and come back and win the game.
First and 10 for Carthage at our 23. 25 seconds left to play in the half, and Bogan Shoots takes a knee. He takes a knee, and assuming no one is inclined to extend this first half, that's going to be it. Here in the first half at Newsom Stadium in Mansfield, no one's calling a timeout yet. We're down to 8 seconds, and it appears that's going to be the first half. Carthage leads it 21-13 over Argyle. We'll return with both bands right after this break. You're listening to Bulldog Football on KGAS.
When you're looking for high-quality personal care from people on whom you can depend, choose East Texas Medical Center in Carthage. The employees are people you know and trust. ETMC Carthage, an East Texas medical tradition. Here when you need them, yet able to refer you when circumstances arise. ETMC Carthage, a tradition of excellence, enhanced by becoming part of a system. ETMC Carthage, proud sponsors of the Carthage High School Battling Bulldogs.
Just-in-time sanitation services has just what you need for residential, construction, commercial, oil field, and special events. From portable toilets to roll-off dumpsters, storage containers, holding tanks, and hand-washing stations, Just-in-time sanitation can help. Dial 903-693-9991. Our commitment is to serve you. Serving all of East Texas and Western Louisiana, Just-in-time sanitation service has what you need to keep it clean and functioning. 903-693-9991. It will be done just in time.
If you don't have an oil well, you need to get one so Ricky and Casey Bagley at Bagley Well Services can help you take care of it. Bagley Well Services is a complete service. Hookups, pipelines, maintenance, backhoe, dozer, and pipe hauling. Bagley Well Service, one call, does it all. 903-622-4122. So if you have an oil well, let Bagley Well Services do the work for you. 903-622-4122.
Well, it's halftime here at Mansfield Stadium as Carthage Bulldogs lead Argyle 21-13. The Argyle band is the visiting band, and there will be the first band to perform, and we'll do our best to pick up their sounds the best we can here with our field mics that we have. Our wireless microphones, neither radio station, by the way, Bradley, the wireless microphones are working. Something has got us, our channels jammed, and we're are having a problem or two. But they have the crowd mics turned on here in the building, so we'll try. How's Mom and the baby?
Mom's good.
They're doing great. Finally starting to sleep a little better. One or two bad nights a week, but nothing we can't handle so far.
All right. Argyle band is actually just kind of standing in a circle on the far sidelines. We'll be able to pick up any of this. See, we'll go down. Pep Squad is standing in front of the band, and I think that we're going to hear more percussion from them than anything else. So it gives us a chance to talk a little bit. The NAMBY contest over. The band did a great job. If some of you in our listening audience was not aware of the National Association of Military Bands competition, this year held in Lufkin?
Nacogdoches.
Nacogdoches, okay. A couple of weeks after the University Interscholastic League competition, and they did a great job, received a superior rating, and actually we come in first, second, third, fourth, and fifth. We came in where?
You know,
I caught you. See, you're supposed to remember those things.
You know, there's a lot been going on since NAMBY. I know they got a superior performance, and they brought home a trophy, which is more than they've done in a long time. First, second, third, fourth. You know,
they were in that top
ranking. They were in the top. I want to say they were somewhere around fourth or fifth. Don't quote me on that. But we're just pleased that they did so well. They stepped up their game at NAMBY, which was great. They brought home a superior performance, which requires that you make you earn so many cumulative points, and they did that. So that was really our goal, for them to succeed in some way at this contest, and they did.
All right, now you say that been working on a few things here. What all have we been doing? Getting ready for All-Region?
Yes, sir. We got All-Region coming up for junior high. It's December 9th. And high school
will
be
2 weeks.
Yes, sir. High school will be December 10th. Both of those are going to be held in ARP, Texas. I did get some numbers for you. According to Mr. Johnson, our 7th grade director, he said we're going to have about 70 junior high kids trying out for region this year.
Wow, very good.
And high school, although our numbers aren't that strong, they are up. We got about 33 by my count going to high school region. Some of those very, very hardworking people. Expect great things from a few of them. So, you know, possibly area, and dare we say it, maybe all the way to San Antonio to state.
Okay, very good. We'll be awaiting and see. And I've heard Mr. Durham have kind words about two or three people who he has high expectations to possibly make their way all the way to state.
Absolutely. I got a few of my own, and Mr. Jones, who's Jim Jones, who's been helping us out. I don't doubt that he has a few that that he has high expectations for. So we're looking to improve on that area as well. We haven't had a student go to area in quite some time. So hopefully we'll get that ball rolling and maybe even take 2, 3, 4, or 5 of them.
Well, we're coming into the December season, getting ready for Christmas. Any of the band programs going to have Christmas concerts coming up?
Yes, sir. Our Christmas parade there in Carthage is December 5th, which junior high and high school will march at separately. But as far as a Christmas concert goes, unfortunately, the high school at this point is kind of at the mercy of the football team, so we don't exactly have just a whole lot of time to prepare for a Christmas concert. But 6th, 7th, and 8th graders are going to put on a concert. That's going to be December 13th. It'll be at the Carthage Junior High Auditorium. Be sometime in the evening, I want to say around 6 or 7 o'clock. I'm not exactly sure what time. I'll get that for you for next week.
Okay.
But 6th graders are working hard. They got a few pieces that they've started working on. Each little section gets to do their little feature piece where just that section has a little snippet of Christmas music that they've been working on. Show mom and dad what they've been learning. Real excited about that.
You get
that.
To thinking about those 6th graders couldn't put their horns together the 1st of September.
Absolutely.
And now you're expecting them to be playing songs that we recognize?
Yes, sir. We do. It's pretty amazing what those kids can do in such a short time. I had a teacher at Baker Coons, our 6th grade campus, come by the other day, and she said, you know, it takes a special person to be a 6th grade band director. And I said, well, you know, we try real hard, and we're patient for a while, and eventually they start making better sounds. So,
very good.
So we're starting to make some music, finally.
If you just joined us, you're listening to KGAS 104.3 FM in Carthage, Texas. We're coming to you live from the Mansfield Independent School District, the Mansfield Stadium, as Carthage is leading Argyle right now, 21-13 at halftime. Battling Bulldog Band will be on the field shortly. We'll be back with more right after this.
Are you or a loved one suffering from a life-limiting illness? Let Heart's Way Hospice be there for you. Our experienced and compassionate team of nurses, social workers, home health aides, and chaplains will help guide you through the difficult days ahead. For more information, please call our office in Carthage, 903-690-9924. You will not walk alone with Heart's Way Hospice.
Walt Sparks at XL Ford in Carthage. For the best selection of cars and trucks in the Ultratex, power, performance, economy, there's nothing like a Ford. XL Ford in Carthage has the best parts, service department in the Ultratex. If you haven't driven a Ford lately, let me personally invite you to come by and take a test drive. Check us out on the internet. We will match or beat any deal in the Ultratex. Still on the South Loop and still number one. God bless America and Semper Fi.
Well, it's time for the Battling Bulldog Band to make their way onto the field, and they stand to the north end zone here at Mansfield Stadium. Mr. Durham giving his last-minute instructions. Bradley, did we change anything from the last week's performance?
Well, not really. We have several students that had Thanksgiving obligations, so there's a few holes out there that... You know, we can never plan for it. But aside from that, the drill is going to be the same as we saw last week. Still going to do a military drill for a little bit of the time. And then we're looking to do the spell out again, which seems to be going pretty well. I believe this is the first time we've been able to do the CHS instead of just a big C for Carthage. Getting some crowd participation with that, so we're pretty pleased that that's going over so well.
The band came in on the north end of the field, the north end zone, and they're marching from the sideline to the far hash mark, so they're off in the far third of the field, and now they halt at midfield. Drum major gives a forward march, and the band comes forward, marching right to the press box. Come on. flag members make their way out, as well as the twirling line. Flags in their red sequin uniform, twirlers in their silver sequins trimmed in red. Everybody wearing the high top boots. And what's the jazz number going to be this time?
You know, I'm pretty sure it's going to be these boots are made for walking. I heard that in passing today. It's kind of been chaotic there getting on the road. But I'm about 85% sure that's what we're going to hear.
All righty. Well, the introduction of the twirling line right now, and next will be the flags. And we can wait here until we start some music. We can go down and listen to them. And this may be a good time for you to read the twirlers and flags
absolutely.
As well.
Absolutely. Our majorettes, captain and senior, Kimberly Ferguson. Junior, Jessica Moore. Sophomores, Kristen Lidke and Brett May. And freshman twirlers, Ashley Andrews, Emily Donald, Kelsey Hooker, Marissa Ingram, Allie Radcliffe, Mia Scott, and Kate Sherman. Our flags for this year, senior and captain, Catherine Cox. Other seniors, Khadijah Ewens, Krista Orbaugh, and Alicia Roberts. Our juniors, Lilia DeJulian and Allison Gert. Sophomores, Cheryl Cheshire, Sonny Morales, Chrislyn Rockmore, and Emily Ward. And our freshman flags, Laniqua Bowman, Cassidy Britton, Kristen Brooks, Charmetria Brown, Alexis Hardy, and Kristen McMullen.
These boots are made for walking. Let's go down and listen. We can stand pretty good here, can't we? Pose at the end of the jazz song. And let's see, they'll go back into the block band now. Pull that down just a little bit. And thank goodness for our prop boys and girls there helping us pick up those props and moving them out of the way.
Yes, sir. Those are some of our junior high band students, so we sure appreciate their help. I tell you what, that group right there, they are dedicated. Those five, I don't think they've missed a game.
Here we go. Festival Prelude Fanfare. Carthage Fanfare, if you would.
There you go.
Fanfare is played. The band is given a forward march by the drum major. Forward march of the Tartar. And then we do that little tag on to get the band into four company fronts. Argyle band standing across the way. And they're over on the sidelines watching the Battling Bulldog Band's military marching band's performance. Tell you what, this is probably unusual for them because they don't see a military marching band, if any, very
right,
seldom.
Right. We talked to North Forney that we played last week?
Uh-huh.
Spoke with their director, and they were very happy that we did some kind of military drill in our show. They don't get to see that very often, and it's good for them to, you know, be exposed to the different marching styles.
Four company fronts now as they move to the south end zone and break out in the blocks as they come up and set up that chevron. Moving now right to left on your radio dial in the chevron in the separate blocks. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 blocks. Now as they hit the 20-yard line, they'll bring that chevron out and make it a traditional chevron that you've seen many times made by the Bulldog Band. And they, as they reach the 40-yard line, they'll come in and do a full band halt, which will establish four company fronts from the 40 to the 35-yard line. And the last group comes in to halt. Water horns immediately to end the song. What can we expect?
Well, this is what Mr. Durham refuses to call the scatter drill. This is a quasi-military march to your spot, which basically puts us in three big blocks getting ready to break out into our spell out.
All right. In other words, take a 30-inch stride and get to your spot and come to a military halt. Pop the corners as you turn, whatever direction you turn.
There you go.
All right. Everybody's in position now. Let's see what happens. There, on the field from the 30-yard line to the 30-yard line, a block, CAGS. All right, CHS spelled out by the Battling Bulldog Band and the fight song played, and Butch Jr. out there right in the middle of everything. And the band makes its way off, moving off to the south end zone. You were about to say something.
Well, I was about to say Becky, the female mascot, if you will, was just about to get run over by the band. I'm not sure she was aware that the band doesn't really stop for anybody.
Oh, yeah, well, but glad nothing happened there. All right. Best of luck at all-region competition for the junior high coming up first and the high school next, and hopefully we'll have an opportunity to visit with you next week as well.
Yes,
and
sir.
And we'll have more information as everything begins.
Absolutely.
All right. Bradley, thank you again, and glad Mom and the new baby are doing fine.
Oh, thank you.
You got a few people you need to thank. I'll let you do that right now.
Before I get into that, I got to tell everybody that Mr. Johnson, Desmond Johnson, our 7th grade director, had to step in and do the public address for halftime today. And I think he just found out about it when we got to the school, and he did a real good job with that spell out. So wanted to make sure everybody knew that was Mr. Johnson doing that. And if you see him, make sure you say thank you for doing such a great job.
Or give him a hard time.
Either way, he was pretty nervous about it. But
did a good job.
We'd like to thank KGAS Radio, Animal Medical Center of Panola County, Bill's Meat Market, Brookshire Brothers, Carthage Title, and Complete Printing. Those are our corporate sponsors. Thank you very much. We'd also like to thank our Carthage Band Boosters, Superintendent Dr. Glenn Hambrick, and High School Principal Mr. Otis Amy, and a big thank you to Miss Leanne Sharp, who is our auxiliary sponsor.
Bradley, we named the twirlers. We named the flag members. Did we name the drum major of the band?
We did not. Daniel LeBlanc, a senior bass clarinet player. Daniel LeBlanc is our drum major this year.
Thanks for your help, and we'll see you next week. Okay?
Absolutely.
At Citizens Bank in Carthage, we want you to not only feel like a customer, but like one of our extended family. Citizens Bank would like to help you build that dream home, buy a first home, or relocate to a larger residence. The friendly loan staff at Citizens Bank can make those dreams come true. Come by our Carthage location and speak to Sonia Hathorn about your options.
Hello, this is Melinda Leslie with Copper Falls & Company, a full-service jewelry and gift store located on the Carthage Square. We also buy gold and silver. Gold has never been this high. Take advantage of these high prices. Come by to see us. Let us weigh your gold and silver, make you an offer. You're under no obligation. We understand that a lot of people want to save their jewelry in a lockbox for their children or grandchildren, but usually they have their own jewelry to wear. So why not sell your gold, take a trip, enjoy life? It's way too short. Give us a call, 903-693-9944.
Your first half stats brought to you by the Fields Law Firm. Are you buying or selling a home? Need a will or do you need estate planning? Hurt in an automobile accident? Accused of a crime or need help with a divorce or child support? Put a bulldog to work for you. Call the Fields Law Firm for your free and confidential consultation. It's 903-693-8888.
All right, here are the first half stats. Argyle with 11 first downs. Carthage had 8 rushing yardage. Argyle with the edge, 82-38. Carthage through the air, 5 of 10 for 117 yards. Argyle, 9 of 19 for 114. So the total yardage, Argyle 196 and Carthage 155. Turnovers in the first half, Argyle had 3. And the Bulldogs had 1, and those turnovers were very big in the first half as far as the scoring was concerned. Argyle punted once for 40 yards and Carthage twice for an average of 27.5. The scoring, Cole Headland gave Argyle a 3-0 lead, 29-yard field goal. Bogan shoots on a 1-yard quarterback sneak. Carthage up 7-3. And then a special play. Bogan shoots a backwards pass to Keach Cage. Back to Bogan shoots and another backwards pass. 50-yard pass downfield by Bogan shoots. Spectacular grab by Ed Pope. Carthage up 14-3. On the ensuing kickoff, Argyle fumble at the 17-yard line. We scored on a 6-yard run by Trent Jackson, and the Dogs were totally in charge, 21-3, 10:36 to play until half. But then Argyle scored on a 1-yard run by Chad Bossal, and that followed a series there, or a play, on which we were offsides, and then offsetting unsportsmanlike conduct penalties against Argyle and Carthage. I understand the Argyle player hit Mario McCain. That was their penalty. Then McCain retaliated, hitting him back, and that was our penalty. Had McCain not retaliated, then Argyle would have been pushed back, and they may not have scored a touchdown on that particular series, but they did. It was 21-10. And then on the ensuing kickoff, Tasker Shannon fumbled for the Bulldogs, and they converted that into a 24-yard field goal. And so it's 21-13 at halftime, and we gave you the halftime stats. The Bulldogs are not out on the field yet in the dressing room. Now they're back out on the field, haven't come through the inflatable Bulldog yet. Argyle is back out on the field as we get ready for the start of the second half. Argyle will get the football first when we have the second half kickoff here in just a moment.
I'll take a break.
At Citizens Bank in Carthage, we want you to not only feel like a customer, but like one of our extended family. Citizens Bank would like to help you build that dream home, buy a first home, or relocate to a larger residence. The friendly loan staff at Citizens Bank can make those dreams come true. Come by our Carthage location and speak to Sonia Hathorn about your options. Citizens Bank is an equal housing lender, member FDIC.
'Cause we stand for your success.
Hello, this is Melinda Leslie with Copper Falls & Company, a full-service jewelry and gift store located on the Carthage Square. We also buy gold and silver. Gold has never been this high. Take advantage of these high prices. Come by to see us. Let us weigh your gold and silver, make you an offer. You're under no obligation. We understand that a lot of people want to save their jewelry in a lockbox for their children or grandchildren, but usually they have their own jewelry to wear. So why not sell your gold, take a trip, enjoy life? It's way too short. Give us a call, 903-693-9944.
Your second half kickoff brought to you by Auto Express Lube in Carthage. They offer you the best in quality products and services. They can change your oil and filter in a flash. Plus, they will fill your windshield washer fluid, vacuum the front seat area, and even wash your windshield. Auto Express Lube, 1112 West Panola. Let's go, Bulldogs.
Well, Mark, one stat I want to get you maybe to comment on. I noticed this as I was doing the stats at halftime. You know, we've made Oney, their quarterback, uncomfortable in forcing him to scramble, but we have yet to get to him. We have yet to sack him, and got to keep putting pressure on that young man.
Oh, yeah. You know, that's the key to their offense is him. You can tell. Their running back doesn't look like he's particularly a threat to break it on you. But we've got to keep our composure. We had a 15-yarder down here, and then we retaliated, and it gave them enough momentum for a touchdown. It was a touchdown, wasn't it? They got
that was when they got the touchdown.
And they would have been out at the 15, 16-yard line on a third down, except we caused a – well, there was another guy hit late, and they had the penalty, and then our guy hit after that. And
yeah, that was a play where there were three penalties. We were offside. And then their guy hits McCain, and then McCain retaliates. If Mario doesn't retaliate, then they're going to have third down from the 16-yard line instead of third from the one. All right, well, that's in the past.
That's hindsight's 2020. We've got 24 minutes of football right here. We're lining up to kick it off. Let's see how our defense responds and how many things they changed in our defensive scheme in halftime. We usually do a pretty good adjustment.
We will have the breeze here in the third quarter. Gonzalez ready to kick it. And here's a high pooch kick. They're going to come up and take it at the 21, up to the 25, the 30, and out to about the 35-yard line. And that's where they will start this possession.
And lucky we didn't get a face mask here. It looked like it was a face mask on that play, but none of the refs were around to see it. But usually under Scott's regime, our second half has always been a little better. In our first half, our defense usually settles in. We've got to figure a way. And when he goes back, what happens is we're covering him. Okay, so then he's electing to run. And we don't have anybody account for him.
All right, we're going to go with just a three-man defensive front. Here's Oney taking off on the left side of the 40, and he's to the 44-yard line. We had a three-man defensive line, and he runs for 9 yards to start the second half.
Yeah, and that may be what's hurting us on those outside runs, that three-down defensive line. Depends on, we've got an extra linebacker in there, but he's off the line of scrimmage. So this is a play they'll usually probably take a shot. We've not seen them take a shot deep.
Now, earlier when we had three, it was Hart, Ware, and Graves. Now it's Hart, Ware, and Adams. All right, snap back to Oney. He hands off to the running back. Coming to his right, and he is tackled by Michi Bowman for a three-yard loss. Make it 2 yards back to the 37.
Well, Michi's played a pretty good game. Early in the game, he shucked the block on the outside and made the tackle, single tackle. Did it again, unassisted. So now it's third down. We need a defensive play right here.
Third down and three. Third and three for Argyle. And this would be huge right here. You're right. Be huge to stop them. They've got the momentum coming out, you know, scoring the last 10 points of the first half. And to stop them right here with their first drive, that would be a biggie. Snap back to Oney in the gun. Oney's looking left. He throws left for the first down. They didn't need much. They needed 3 yards, and they pick up five on that pass play.
It was again at number three, a little slant inside. But We need to stop here on defense here to start the second half.
They gained six on that play, as it turns out. 6 yard gain to the Argyle 48. So it's now first and 10 for Argyle at their own 48. Carthage leading 21-13. Oney, as he has been most of the half, in the shotgun, snap back to him. He hands off to Eveleth, coming to his right, and he is wrapped up for no gain. In fact, that's going to be a loss of a yard there. Nice play by Villanueva.
Villanueva, that's been the hardest name for me to say this year, but he played a heck of a play then. He's in as our fourth linebacker when we go to the three-down line set, and he's doing a heck of a job tonight. That's exactly his position, to run through that line of scrimmage and make a tackle for a loss.
Okay, so now it's 2nd and 11 for Argyle from their own 47. Oney in the gun, snap back to him. Now he's looking to pass over the middle, good protection. Now he's going to pull it down and run with it, being chased by Hart around left end to the 50, to the 45, and out of bounds for a first down. He's got a first down at the Bulldog 41-yard line.
Yeah, and he made a move on somebody out there on defense and left him in his shoes and got to the outside after that. I don't know who it was.
12 yards for Austin Oney. I'm telling you, he's the real deal as a quarterback, outstanding quarterback, and he's seasoned, as Mark said earlier. He's a senior. First and 10 for Argyle. Handoff goes to Eveleth. Eveleth straight up the middle, and he gets a big hole this time, straight up the middle for about 11 yards to our 30.
And our coaches are out there waving, wanting something to happen. Now we're bringing in a fourth defensive lineman. We're going to go back to a three-linebacker set with 9:32 left in the third quarter, 21-13. We're ahead.
Okay, we'll give him 10 to the 31, 10 yards to the 31-yard line. Snap back to Oney in the guns, play action fake. Now he wants to throw it. He's going to run with the football. He's to the 30 and trying to go to his right now and is cut down at the 27, a gain of 4.
D.K. Callaway on the tackle after he came out from the pocket. He cut to the right, and he played his position as he should.
All right, so we're going with four down linemen, and Bry Anderson's going to come in and give McCain a rest. You know, McCain goes both ways. So it's going to be Hart, Anderson, Ware, and Adams, the four-man defensive front for the Bulldogs. Second and 6 for Argyle from our 27, from the Carthage 27. Down to 5 seconds on the play clock. Oney in the gun, snap back to him, looking over the middle, throws over the middle, incomplete, threw it behind the intended receiver that time, and it's going to be third down.
Yeah, this will bring up a good play. Young man looks like he might have could have caught that ball. The way we've been hitting him, he looked like he just kind of made a halfway attempt to catch it because there was footsteps he could hear.
That was Ian Sadler, the intended receiver, a sophomore who was out the first three district games and sort of 50% from what I read, the last two district games, and he's come back pretty much full strength in the playoffs. Now it's third down and six for Argyle at the Carthage 27. Another big third down play here. Snap back to Oney. Oney hands off to the running back, and he's across the 25 to about the 23. He's going to be short of the first down by about a couple of yards.
And this is probably no man's land. This is fourth down territory. Unless they know they've got that field goal kicker can kick it from this far, they'll go for it. This looks like about 2 or 3 yards for the first down. 8:15 left third quarter. And let's see what they do here. Big play.
They are going to go for it on fourth down and two. Fourth and two for Argyle at the Carthage 23. Fourth and two at the Bulldog 23-yard line. Oney's going to be in the gun.
Timeout.
And he's
got
to call a timeout. They're running out of time. All right, we take a break here.
All right. This will be a good time. Dustin, let's kind of check on you. Are you able to pick us up, and have you got you a better vantage point?
Yeah, I can hear you. If y'all can hear me, a little hot sounds what it sounds like. But, yeah, Argyle's doing a good job of just mixing up the run, their pass. And as Mark said, you know, our secondary is doing a great job in pass. But he doesn't like to hold it real long. Our defense hasn't really. And really hasn't got a good push to get any sacks on him. He's just going to take off if he doesn't find something open right when he wants to throw it.
All right. Well, knowing where Dustin is now, we'll go to him. And we've got a reliable wireless source right now. He is up here in the press box on our level in the filming deck. 7:58 to play in the third quarter. Argyle has taken the second half kickoff here. And they have now fourth and two at the Carthage 23-yard line. Carthage leading 21-13. So Argyle has controlled it the first 4 minutes and 2 seconds here of the third quarter. Incidentally, I understand at halftime that they had 16 more plays than we did. So they have controlled the ball here in the ball game. Their three turnovers have been big. We've only got three men on the defensive line this time. Only a three-man defensive front for the Bulldogs. Oney's going to be in the gun. Fourth down and two. Snap back to Oney. Oney looking left. Now he's going to be forced to run with it. He throws, and it's going to be complete for a first down. They needed 2 yards, and they got 3 to the 20.
Yeah, it was just good quarterbacking right there. He rolled to his left and found a man out in the flat. And just good quarterbacking.
All right, first down and 10. Go ahead, Mark. I'm sorry.
That's all right. Just a good throw.
First and 10 for Argyle at the Carthage 20-yard line. Ball is on the left hash. Argyle going from our left to right here in the third quarter. Argyle in black pants, white jerseys, black numbers. They wear a black helmet. All right, a wide out to the right goes motion left. Here's a play action fake. Oni rolling to his right. He's throwing downfield. This ball is caught at the five, and he's into the end zone for a touchdown. That was Chad Bossal. Bossal with the 20-yard touchdown reception, and it's now 21-19.
Yes, I'll see if they'll go for two here to try to tie it. And that was just a good play by the quarterback right there. We're going to have to play some offense this half because they're going to score some.
7:30 to play in the third quarter. And Argyle trailing by two is going to go for two. They're going to go for two to try to tie it up here. And as they do in a short yardage situation, Oni goes under center. Now they have a wing to the right. And here's Oni pitching out to the runner going to his right. And he is going to get into the end zone for the two-point conversion. So taking it in there was Ian Sadler, the sophomore. And we now have a tie ball game, 21-21, 7:30 to play in the third. Back right after this.
What's your biggest concern when the weather is cold? A problem with your heater or electrical system? Well, Hal and Bruce Whitaker are the names you know and trust to calm your fears. Hal and Bruce at Hal's AC and Electric know electricity. They'll help you stay warm and keep your systems running properly. Whether it's residential, commercial, industrial, or oil field work, Hal's AC and Heating is the one to call at 903-693-7451. Quick, dependable service. They sell Amana, Train, and Goodman, but service all brands. Hal and Bruce Whitaker, the names that you know and trust.
Attention hunters, Bill's Meat Market in Carthage is ready to process your deer, wild hog, or elk, providing regular cuts, smoked sausage, even summer sausage and jerky. Remember, by law, you must deliver your kill skinned, gutted, and in a nice chest. Bill says it's time to order those holiday hams and turkeys, smoked, fried, or fresh. Catering is also available for the holiday parties. Bill's Meat Market and Catering, 1317 West Panola, 693-6122. Bill's in Carthage. They have great food.
We've got different guys lined up. Our good hands people, looks like, Larry. Thinking there may be some trickery.
All right, Headland getting ready to kick off. He'll be kicking into the wind. And Dustin, going to go to you after this kickoff. Dustin, we're about to see what we're made of here. Argyle has scored 18 straight points after we were up 21-3. And they definitely are feeling it right now. They've got the momentum. Okay, here's Tasker Shannon at the 29 to the 30, 35, and out of bounds at the 36-yard line. Okay, Dustin.
Yeah, that's right. They've actually shut us out for about the past 15 minutes going back to the second quarter. But you're right. You know, we're about to get a stop on defense. You know, we're putting them in some third and short situations and some fourth down situation. But what they've been doing all night in their passing game is going to their tight end, Chad Bossal, number three. He's just been kind of sneaking in behind the linebackers and in front of the safeties, and the quarterback has been finding them. So, but, you know, we're going to get some momentum going on here in offense, and we're going to score some points because we really hadn't had a good sustained drive all 21.
Okay, we have not scored
going here on offense.
We have not scored since 10:36 of the second quarter. So let's see, that would be over 15 minutes now. We have not scored. All right, here's a pitch out to Pipkin. Pipkin going right to the 40. Pipkin across the 40 and out to about the 44, maybe the 45-yard line. We need a good drive here. We've got to have a score here. That's going to be 7 yards on first down.
Yeah, we need to go back to our run game. Now, you know Surratt, you never can tell what he's going to do, but we can take the ball and just run it down and run some time off the clock ourselves.
All right, here comes a special play. A pitch out goes to Pipkin going left. Pipkin trying to get to the outside and is brought down. That was a special play. He gets 2 yards on that play. I think it'll be a first down.
Well, I tell you what, they have two linebackers, and they're both pretty good athletes, and our guys just didn't block them at all. We're blocking, just passed them up. Can't do that. That number 43 has been playing pretty good all night.
That was a special play. We had the center and then a player on his right, and then everyone was to the left, and the pitch out went to Pipkin, straight from the center to Pipkin going left. 2 yard gain and a first down. And here's the handoff. It goes to Pipkin. Pipkin, 50, 45, spins down to the 41-yard line of Argyle. Nice run by Tevin Pipkin. That's going to be a gain of 12, and they'll move the chains.
Yeah, we can go back to this just power running, and we've got the hogs up front to handle that. And we may have to do this. Maybe change our game plan and just run.
Speaking of power running, I saw before the ball game, Hunter Holland here, home for the holidays from the Air Force. Boy, I tell you what a guy he was, what a runner he was last year, a durable runner. And the Bulldogs need that right now, some durability, a time-consuming scoring drive here. First and 10 at the Eagle 41-yard line. Ball on the left hash. Here's a play-action fake. Bogan Schuster wants to throw it. Now he's going to run with it. He throws it downfield and overthrows Pipkin, who was wide open to the 15-yard line.
That looked like the play, if y'all watched the Cowboys the other night, when Tony Romo rode out and then found Jason Witten going down the middle. That's almost the same type of play. He was wide open. We just didn't hit the pass.
Wow. Okay, Dustin, I tell you what, we'll go down to go to you after this next play to get your comments right there. Blake had him and just flat overthrew it. I don't know how much of a factor the wind was on that play. We do have the wind at our back here in this quarter. Twins to the right, one to the left. Bogan shoots under center. Second and 10 for Carthage at the Eagle 41-yard line. 21-21 tie. Hand off Pipkin. Pipkin going left. Gets away from one to tackler. To the 40, down to the 36-yard line. Okay, Dustin.
Yeah, he kind of made a good throw. He stepped up in the pocket, kind of threw it off his, you know, his back right foot, which is the right foot to throw it off, and just kind of opened. But offensive line is starting to get offensive line and get pushing open up holes. There is, you know, as far as moving the ball, we got to beat that third.
I tell you, we've tried Dustin everywhere tonight and has had some problems. We need to get the blimp up. So I think up there we might have a clear signal. All right, let's see. The Dogs now third and five. Third and five at the Argyle 36-yard line. Bogan shoots in the gun. Snap back to Blake. Blake, good protection, throws left. It's caught by Shannon. Shannon breaks a tackle to the 30, 25-20. Inside to the 15-yard line. First and 10, Dogs down at the 15-yard line after a 21-yard completion.
Yes, and if we keep going to him and then get him to sleep on Pope, then we'll have another play on the other side of the field.
21-yard pass from Bogan shoots to Shannon, and it's first and 10 now for the Dogs at the Argyle 15-yard line. First order of business, score here. Pope goes wide to the right. That's the wide side of the field, single coverage out there. Shannon, single coverage to the left. Bogan shoots under center, double tight end formation. Hand off Pipkin. Pipkin up the middle, down to the 10, inside the 10, down to the 9-yard line. And a good gain on first down of 6 yards. It'll be second and four from the 9.
Yeah, I mean, the guy on defense did a good job there because he went through the line of scrimmage and was untouched, and a guy brought him down single-handedly. At number 43, that linebacker, he has been all over the field.
43 is the brother of that tight end. That's Karsten Bossal.
Okay.
All right, now second and four, and here's a quarterback sneak by Bogan Schutz. He needed four, and I think he got three to the 6-yard line. It's going to be third down and one at the 6.
That's a weird call from 4 yards out. I guess they saw something in the film that they could get a good push up the middle, which they did get a real good push. We're bringing in the heavy package now. Bankhead coming in with Klassen, and Jackson coming in as running back. Dakota Hart's already in there on as a tackle or a tight end.
Okay, so we've got the jumbo package, which includes one of our offensive guards. Mario McCain is a blocker in the backfield, along with Klyson, the fullback, and Jackson is the tailback. Third and one, handoff to Jackson. Jackson in the middle, and boy, he is hit hard. He did not get it that time. He did not get it.
That's the first time that play's been stopped for us that small a gain, and then we run. So we're going to have to run it again here. If we can, line up in that formation and do a bootleg out.
Big decision here for Scott Surratt. Do you go again on fourth and one, or do you take the field goal here? And he's out visiting with Bogan Schutz, down to 18 seconds on the play clock. Bogan Schutz into the huddle now with 14 seconds left. And we're going to go with the jumbo package once again. Fourth down and one. Oh, this is a key play right here. Fourth and one at the Argyle 6. Handoff goes to Jackson. Jackson hitting the backfield, and he will not get it. Argyle holds. It's a one-yard loss. They hold, and they'll take over at their 7-yard line.
Yeah, they had penetration on the defensive line. Of course, when they know you're going to run, they're more active, you know, at the line of scrimmage. But that was a heck of a drive to end inside the 10-yard line. And that may hurt us in the end of this game.
That is a big play right there. Okay, Dustin's now in here with us. Okay, Dustin, so we'll get your comments on those last couple of plays where we went with a jumbo package after this next play by Argyle. Again, the Bulldogs stuffed on fourth down and one from the Argyle 6-yard line, a loss of one. Okay, Oney in the gun. Snap back to Oney. Oney hands off to the running back, Eveleth. Eveleth straight up the middle, and he picks up about 6 yards out to the 12. Okay, Dustin.
Yeah, we didn't get a good pushing by our offensive line there, and they had the guy in the backfield pretty much as soon as the ball was snapped, and it hit Trent. Trent was able to actually bounce off of it and try and get the first down, but we were short, and, you know, they're doing a pretty good job pushing our defensive line. You know, they got about seven, six yards on that run.
Okay, gain of six there out to the 13. It's second down and four. Second and four for Argyle from their own 13-yard line. Snap back to Oney in the gun. Hand off to Eveleth. Eveleth going right now, cuts up the middle, and he's got a first down across the 15 to the 19, a gain of six for Eveleth.
Yeah, just good offensive push there, just like our offensive line took control a while ago, went down the field. Their offensive line is doing the same thing here.
All right, 2:20 to play in the third quarter. We've got a 21-21 tie, but the momentum in this game now rests with Argyle. I thought we were going to get it back. Oh, here's a flag coming in against Argyle. That'll be a false start.
Yes, false start on them. But you could tell it about half their linemen fired off like they missed.
And again, we have not scored since 10:36 to play in the second quarter, so that'd be 10:36 there. And in this quarter, that would be 9:50. So we have not scored in over 20 minutes. 20 minutes and 26 seconds of playing time, we have not scored.
We need to get them right here.
All right, it's now first down and 15. Here's Oney. Oney back to throw. Great protection. Now he's going to run with it. Going to his right, he throws, and this one is incomplete. Looked like maybe the closest player to that was D.K. Callaway. In fact, he might have got a hand on it.
Yeah, and that was good. He was thrown into a bunch of red right there. That was probably an ill-advised throw, but this is when we need to make a stand, field position-wise and all. We need to stop them right here, make them punt. We'll get to about midfield, maybe a little deeper. This is a play.
Second down and 15. Second and 15 for Argyle from their own 15-yard line. Need a big play here. Three-man defensive front. Snap back to Oney in the gun. He's going to throw. Has a man open, and it's incomplete. He had a man open at the 33-yard line, and we had a man behind him, Shannon, who would have made sure it wasn't a big, big gain, but he overthrew him, and it's now third down.
Yeah, we need another play here, right here on defense. Yeah, he had it looked like the one bogey threw a while ago. He just overthrew his man, which was wide open.
We've made him uncomfortable tonight. I'm talking about Oney, but we have yet to sack him. We put some pressure on him, but for the most part, we haven't got enough pressure. Snap back to Oney in the gun. Oney's going to run with it now up the middle. He's to the 20, 25, and out across the 25 to the 28, but he's going to be short of the first down. He needed 15, and he got 13.
Yeah, and it's an interesting call here to see how they're going to bring their punt team in, but that would be a tough call to not make it here.
A good stop by the defense there.
They have to punt it here. And that penalty turned out to be a biggie. That got them back deep in the hole, and now they're forced to kick it. The line of scrimmage is going to be the 28-yard line, and he takes a 13-yard drop, rugby-style kick, and a pretty good one, too. Here's Bowman taking it at the 30. He's to the 35 and stopped at the 36-yard line.
That ball had a lot of air under it, gave his coverage time to get down there. Meachie had four guys to look at just as soon as he got the ball, but he held on to it. We've got pretty decent field position. We can go down here and take this lead.
Boy, that's a heck of a punt right there. 42 yards. 42 yards into a little bit of a breeze, and Carthage now has it first and 10 at our 36. So even though we have not scored in over 20 minutes of playing time, 21 now, the game is still tied. The Bulldogs had a big lead at one time, 21-3. Argyle has come back to score the last 18 points of the game. It's 21-21, 57 seconds to play in the third quarter. Here's a handoff to Pipkin. Pipkin trying to get to the outside on the left to the 35-40, 45, and knocked out of bounds in front of the Carthage bench. And here's a late flag coming in at the 47-yard line, a late flag on a hit on Pipkin out of bounds, and that's going to tack on 15.
And our boys are mounting a little bit too, but that was a really late hit. So that's going to give us another 15.
Got 50 seconds left in the third quarter. Scores 21 up. Bulldogs in a dogfight.
This third quarter has really gone by quick here in the second half.
All right, that's a 11-yard gain for Pipkin, and they should mark it off from the 47. So that should take it to the Argyle 38.
That's where he's standing.
If the umpire gets his math down right, and that's where he's going to put it. All right, a 15-yard penalty against Argyle. And now we have it at the Argyle 38 with 50 seconds to play in the third quarter. Bogan shoots under center. Bogan shoots. Play action fake. He's going to throw it. Here's some pressure coming up the middle. He throws it to the left and throws it pretty much out of bounds, and that's going to be an incomplete pass, and they do not rule grounding there. I tell you what, that 44 has put some pressure on him tonight on several occasions, and that's going to make it now second down and 10.
For the 44 and 43, both are real active on the field. But that was a good play by a sophomore quarterback. Get rid of it. We've seen the senior quarterback from them throwing the ball away a couple of times tonight. That was a good way to get rid of it, be sure when nobody was around.
Yeah, and Argyle was coming with a blitz on that side, the play action play there as well.
All right, we've got some late substitutions coming in, and we have to call a timeout, and Surratt is really fit to be tied at somebody. All right, I think he's talking to Tasker Shannon. He's the one getting the most of his conversation. All right, we'll take a break now. 44 seconds to play in the third quarter. We'll be back from Mansfield right after this.
Basic Energy Services of East Texas serves East Texas and Northern Louisiana with quality, dependable oil field service. Their services include acidizing, cementing work, work over rigs, and hauling salt water. If you have an oil well in East Texas, you need to know Basic Energy Services of East Texas. Basic Energy Services, proud supporters of all our area schools.
Well, I'll tell you what, that could cost us later in the ballgame, that timeout.
Yeah, I think what happened, Mark, was is Tasker Shannon was on the sidelines. I don't know if he's getting some equipment fixed or whatnot, and Surratt called a play with the formation, and Tasker wasn't in there, and then they had to try to run Major Harris out there.
Which could have been a penalty.
I think we may have had too many men on the field, and then Surratt went ahead and called the timeout, but Tasker was over here on the sidelines because he was actually running back towards Surratt when the play was about to start.
All right, so it's second down and 10. We've now used our first timeout, second and 10 for Carthage at the Argyle 38. 44 seconds to play in the third quarter in a 21-21 tie. Bogan shoots under center. Three-step drop. He's throwing right. It's caught by Shannon at the 30, and he's upended. Nice play to hang onto the football, and that's going to be a 12-yard gain to the 26 and a first down.
Yeah, that was a good old slant coming from the numbers into the hash marks, and he threw a good ball, good catch. First down, he did get upended pretty hard.
But all right, go ahead. First and 10 for the Bulldogs at the Argyle 26. Ball on the right hash, and this time it's going to Pope splitting to the right. We've got Klyson a wing right. Shannon split out to the left. Now Klyson goes motion left, and here's the handoff. It goes to Pipkin. He's coming left. He's to the 25. Breaks the tackle to the 26 on his feet to the 15, to the 10. Inside the 10, and he's up in it at the 6-yard line. It's going to be a 20-yard run for Pipkin.
Oh, we have an injured man on the field. Let's go to the home office for pace and build.
There's never been a better time to buy a new Camry than right now at Marshall Toyota. I'm Danny Cole, and today you can buy a 2011 Camry LE fully loaded with a $1,000 rebate and zero interest. If you lease, you'll get a special lease payment. Our selection is good, our staff is great, and ready to give you more details. Our service after the sale is second to none. Call us at 903-938-9026, on the web at marshalltoyota.com, or better yet, visit us at 5015 East End Boulevard, south in Marshall.
Tires are not all the same, and neither are tire dealers. So find a dealer who carries Michelin and BF Goodrich tires. Michelin offers safe, fuel-efficient, long-lasting tires that provide exceptional performance and extraordinary value. BF Goodrich tires are built for drivers looking for high performance and aggressive styling. Next time you need tires, don't deal with amateurs. See the tire experts at Carthage Discount Tire and Brake. Stop on by or visit their website at CarthageDiscountTire.com.
We have an official timeout on the field with an injury. We'll be right back.
At Devon Energy, we believe that to be a good company, we must first be a good neighbor. Our commitment runs deep in our relationships with the people of East Texas. Our employees are neighbors, mentors, leaders, and community volunteers. In Panola County, Devon Energy is a proud supporter of all area schools. Devon Energy Corporation, Carthage.
Hi, this is Steve Langford from Farmer State Bank. If you've been thinking about buying a new house, property, car, boat, or maybe even something else, now is the time. Loan interest rates are at an all-time low. Come in and talk to a Farmer State Bank loan officer today. We cannot wait for you to join our family. Farmers is an FDIC member and equal housing lender.
Reliable Healthcare in Carthage offers medical equipment and medical supplies. Wheelchairs, hospital beds, canes, walkers, incontinence supplies. They have it all. Call 903-694-2285. Reliable Healthcare is approved by Medicare and Medicaid. They also accept private insurance payments. Professional answers to all your medical questions. Your complete source of medical equipment and supplies is Reliable Healthcare. And now they have scrubs for your professional look. Reliable Healthcare in Carthage.
If you're thinking about working on your own car, whether you're replacing your brakes, changing the oil, or even just replacing the wiper blades, you need to head to Toledo Automotive in Carthage. Toledo Automotive always has the parts you need when you need it, no matter what the job is. And if they don't, they'll get it for you. Toledo Automotive in Carthage is also your authorized distributor of Mack truck parts in the Carthage area. When something goes wrong, check with the friendly, knowledgeable staff at Toledo Automotive, your NAPA dealer in Carthage. 903-693-7806.
Well, we've had an extensive or long injury timeout here, but we're very happy to report that the young man, Matt Ryan of Argyle, is walking slowly off the field. I don't know exactly what happened, but well, he was immediately attended to. Boy, there were a bunch of people very concerned about him.
Pipkin lowered his shoulder and ran over him, and he never moved after. He just laid in the same position, so that's a scary thought. I didn't see him move his arms or his legs, but they did get him up, and I think he has a concussion.
Yeah, what it looked like is he was going after Tevin's knees to hit him, and Tevin kind of lowered his shoulders. And, you know, if you take a knee to a helmet and the head, you know, you can get a concussion real quick.
All right, well, he's going off the field slowly, and is going up the tunnel. So I don't think he will be back. 16 seconds, and the clock starts now. First and goal for Carthage at the Argyle 6-yard line. Bogan shoots under center. And here's a play-action fake. Bogan shoots rolling to his right. He throws. It is caught by Cage, and, boy, they have that one snuffed out in a hurry. It's going to be a loss back to about the 8-yard line, a loss of two.
Yeah, and we had men downfield, offensive linemen downfield, and they'll get you a penalty every time.
And that is the end of the third quarter. Carthage and Argyle in a 21-21 tie. We'll be back from Mansfield right after this.
The ladies at the Popcorn Place invite you to get happy this Christmas season. Get happy by checking out their all-new Get Happy collections. Each Friday from now until Christmas, the Popcorn Place will offer a Friday special day sale. Don't forget the big Christmas open house, December the 2nd at the Popcorn Place. Check them out on their Facebook. What a great place to shop, the Popcorn Place in Carthage.
Make stopping at the fill-in station one of your daily routines. Stop in before school or work for some delicious breakfast burritos, biscuits with egg and sausage, and fresh-made breakfast toasters. They always have those wonderful Crispitos. And while you're there, pick up lunch items. The deli has corn dogs, fried chicken, pizza sticks, chicken tenders, potato logs, as well as barbecue sandwiches and chicken sandwiches. Not to mention Bluebell ice cream and cold drinks. The fill-in station on West Sabine, locally owned by Bill and Donna Arnold. Hope to see you soon.
12 minutes left here at Mansfield. Argyle and Carthage in a 21-21 tie. The Bulldogs for the second time in the third quarter, and now here in stretching into the fourth quarter in the red zone. And the first time we were stuffed on fourth down and one at our 6-yard line. And now we have it second down and goal from the 8 after a 2-yard loss on that pass play. Second and goal from the 8. Bogan shoots is going to go under center this time. He's got two receivers to the left, one to the right, tight end left. And here is a play action fake. Bogan shoots rolling to his right. It's thrown to Pipkin. Pipkin is caught and down inside the 1-yard line, right at the 1. So it's going to be a gain of 7 down to the 1. And it's now third and goal. And here comes the jumbo package in again.
Yes, we know. They stopped us well ago, but we've got two chances at it right now. Because we're probably not going to kick a field goal here. So
You know, we've already squandered one, like Larry said, inside the 20. Let's get the play in. Let's get it run.
All right, jumbo package in there. So you've got McCain, a big offensive lineman in the backfield as an extra blocker, two tight ends. Klassen's in there in the backfield, handoff Jackson. Jackson on the left side. Touchdown, Jackson. Trent Jackson goes in from 1 yard, and the Bulldogs regain the lead here, 27-21.
Thank goodness we had that cushion at the start when we got ahead 21-3, and the best they've done is come back and tie us. And now the best they can do, I guess they could go for two to beat us. The best thing they can do is, as soon as we make our extra point, that they got to come back and score a touchdown. That's another thing, too. Not a field goal, a touchdown.
You know, and this is a decisive extra point, too, as well.
Right.
And, again, this is into a little bit of a breeze. Now, Jimmy had no trouble in the first half kicking into the wind on an extra point, and they converted a field goal into the breeze. The snap is back. The kick is away. It looks good. It's right down the middle. It is good. And it's 28-21. Carthage 11-16 to play in the fourth. Back from Mansfield right after this.
Are you tired of being just another policy number? Call Tate Barber at State Farm, where we still believe in the old version of the golden rule. Treat others as you want to be treated. If trustworthy service is as important to you as it is to him, then go buy today. They don't want to just write your insurance. They want to take the time to customize a policy to fit your individual insurance needs and become your agent and friend for life. Call Tate Barber today at State Farm, 903-693-7555.
HEB is your hometown and neighborhood grocery store where you'll always find friendly faces, affordable prices, and quality products. HEB in Carthage has the finest produce and meat combined with trustworthy brands to keep your grocery bill low. Why waste your time and gas going out of town when your local HEB has everything that you need at prices that you'll love? HEB in Carthage. Here, everything is better.
Well, with Trent Jackson, who came in with six touchdowns for the year, he now has two here in this ball game, and that touchdown gives the Bulldogs a 28-21 lead after the extra point. And now we're going to have to stop Argyle.
Wouldn't it be fun if you were a running back like him, and all you did, they bring you in at the 2 yard line, you score, and you get your name in the paper. You know, you scored all these touchdowns, and you've only run the ball. I bet he only have 100 yards rushing all year.
If that.
That's right. He had one good long run against Gilmer, it seemed like. But other than that, he's been...
That's right. Okay, here's the sky kick by Gonzalez. Fair catch they're going to make at the 29-yard line. And that made by the sophomore wideout for the Argyle Eagles. So they're going to have it now at their own 29 with 11-16 to go in the ball game.
A stop is all we need, really, isn't it, Red?
Well, I think really two for sure, maybe three, depending on what happens. I'll give you a final game score. Henderson won big tonight, 42-19 over Salina. You know, Salina has a hard time beating these East Texas teams for sure.
All right, Awney in the gun, ball on the right hash. Again, Awney in the gun. Rossell, the tight end, is over on the right side. Here's a handoff to Eveleth. Eveleth coming left. Got running room, 35-40. Out across the 40. Still on his feet. We're trying to yank the ball away. And we do, but it's going to be blown dead. We finally pulled it out, but the play was blown dead at the 47-yard line. And that's going to be a first down, a gain of 18. That's their biggest running play of the night.
Well, yeah, and we gave them five of it by trying to pull the ball out. If we had tried to pull them down, he wouldn't have got that extra 5 yards. Clock runs, 11 minutes left, 28-21 Carthage.
All right, first and 10 for Argyle at their own 47. Awney is in the gun. Rossell, the tight end, over on the right side. Twins to the right, one to the left. Hand off Eveleth. Eveleth going to his right this time. Gets away from a tackler. He's across midfield as he starts to pick up some yardage here in the second half. And if they start to run it effectively, then it's going to be tough to stop them because of their passing game also. Okay, that's a gain of six.
10:33 left.
Yeah, Argyle's just really trying. They're trying to run outside. We got an injury timeout here. One of our players looks like he's cramping up. We'll go ahead and take a commercial break.
Courtney Construction of Carthage knows the oil field and pipeline business. Courtney Construction provides equipment and labor for pipeline jobs, facility installations and repairs, compressor installations, pit closures and reclamations. Courtney Construction can provide the equipment, personnel, and resources required to install up to 24-inch pipe. Courtney Construction has the labor, the equipment, and the know-how. So call 903-694-2911. Courtney Construction, Highway 79 North in Carthage.
Okay, that's Callaway coming out. Yes, D.K. Callaway, who replaced, of course, Ricky Ingram. And going in to replace him is Gabe Villanueva. Second down and four now. Second and four for Argyle at the Dog 47. Awney in the gun. Snap back to him. Hand off to Eveleth. Eveleth going right to the 45. Inside the 45 to the 40-yard line. And to the 39, he's got a first down there.
You just figure out, you know, we would figure a way to stop that, because all they do is just running right outside. He hands it off to him. He runs around the end. And they're being successful on this drive, especially. 10-18 left. Bulldogs are ahead 28-21. Defense needs a stop.
Gain of eight there. We're up by a touchdown. Clock is running with 10:08 to go. Argyle again down by just one score right now. Trying to go in and tie it up. Awney in the gun. Snap back to him. Hand off to Eveleth. This time coming to his left. He's across the 35 and down to about the 32-yard line. And whereas we were controlling him early, we're not right now. Gain of seven.
No, they're just lining it up just like we did and just running it. Whoever has this ball last is going to win this game.
Yeah, we're not doing a real good job on our outside with either our outside linebacker defensive end to try and getting and cut him off and getting upfield and, you know, making a tackle upfield instead of downfield.
Second down and three. Second and three for Argyle at the Carthage 32-yard line. Ball is on the left hash. Awney's going to be in the shotgun. 7 seconds left on the play clock. Down to five. Snap back to Awney in the gun. Awney being pressured. Awney throws it at the last second. The flag on the play. And he's going to be stopped after the reception at the 29-yard line.
And then Hankey's on the field. So that's going to be probably a hold. And that's when we've been successful against them tonight, when we've got them in second and third and long, make them do something they don't like to do.
That was the closest we've come to sacking Awney tonight, and it's going to be a 10-yard mark off from the previous spot, which will take it back to the 42-yard line.
Yeah, and, you know, that showed how good an athlete he threw that ball with the other hand.
He did, didn't he?
Yeah, he moved it and threw it with his left hand, and the ball floated perfect for a catch. But this is a play right here. We need to stop them. Make them go to third and long.
Second and 12 for Argyle at our 42. Snap back to Awney. Another flag comes in.
Must be a false start. It is.
All right. Another penalty against Argyle. We'll move it back to the 47-yard line now. We got to stop them on this series, don't we?
We really need to.
We've got to stop them. But, you know, they could be in four-down territory, so you could be looking at having to have three stops here with them looking at second and 17.
But if we make a good stop here, then it's going to put them in a long situation.
Second and 17. We almost come across. That's Hart, but he gets back. Second and 17. Now down to 9 seconds on the shot clock. I mean, the play clock. Snap back to Awney. Awney throws to his right. It's caught out there at the midfield marker, and we stop him for a short gain. Very short. Remember, they needed 17 yards, and they got five on the play to the 41.
Now, this is when we need to make a play, because we want them fourth down and long, too. We don't want them fourth and two. We want them fourth and long. That way, they'll just about have to punt.
Fourth and 12. Fourth and 12 for Argyle at the Carthage 41. Big play here. 8:20 to go in the ball game. Snap back to Awney in the gun. Awney looking left. Throws over the middle, and this ball is caught. No, it's knocked away. Great play there by Tasker Shannon. Shannon knocked it out of his hands, and
we may have
gotten a penalty right there.
We got to
celebrate. That may be a taunting penalty on Shannon. Could be. The young man is writhing in pain on the turf. And we may have just picked up a taunting penalty. There's going to be an injury timeout here. We'll take a break here in Mansfield.
At First State Bank and Trust Company, we understand how important a dependable, independent bank is to growing families, farms, and businesses. That's the reason you'll find a level of respect and customer service here that is uncommon today. If that sounds like the kind of strong, can-do bank you're looking for, Come let us show you more. A lot more. First State Bank and Trust Company, Carthage. Deep in the heart of Panola County.
Since 1951, Pippin Motor Company has been serving you, the residents of Panola and surrounding counties. Hi, I'm Will Blackwell, and I want to personally invite you to buy your next newer pre-owned vehicle from us. Quality GM products, top dollar for trade-ins, low interest rates, large rebates, and a no-pressure sales experience. What better place to buy your next new or pre-owned vehicle? That's Pippin Motor Company across from Panola College, 693-6691, or on the web at pippinmotorcompany.com.
Well, it's already...
Ken Turner Pharmacy on the square in downtown Carthage has what you need to make you feel better. Not only will Ken Turner Pharmacy fill your prescription promptly, they'll also deliver it to your door. That way you can stay in bed and get better. Whether it's medication you need or a special gift from our gift shop that no one else will have, stop by Ken Turner Pharmacy. Ken Turner Pharmacy on the square in Carthage, where Carthage's finest tradition.
All right, a big hit by Tasker Shannon. The ball was right on the mark by Austin Ani, and it was knocked out of the hands of the intended receiver on an incredible blow by Shannon that he applied on Ian Sadler, the sophomore wideout. And evidently, Tasker is being called here for unsportsmanlike conduct. Don't know if it was what he said or just the fact that he celebrated the hit.
Might have been somebody else in there, too.
I think what it is, Larry, was he didn't get over the player and taunt or anything like that, and he didn't throw his hands up or say anything to him. It was when they were walking away from him, nothing was said. They were just kind of throwing their hands up in there toward our crowd, and then I guess the official didn't like that and threw a flag on him. You know, it's kind of one of those deals where he wasn't over him or say anything to him. He was walking away from it.
That could be really costly. That would have brought up fourth down there, fourth and 12. So instead now it's first and 10 for Argyle at our 26. Handoff goes to the running back coming to the left, and he's upended after about a three-yard gain to the 23.
Adams on the tackle. Gilmer's winning 46-14, fourth quarter.
Yeah, that was iffy there. You know, he wasn't – you're right, he was not standing over him. At any rate, it goes against us.
Might have said something, too. Might have said something and called for.
Yeah, might have. We're not down there to know what happened. 7:40 to go in the ball game. Second and seven now for Argyle at our 23-yard line. Second and seven. Snap back to Awney. Awney going to run it himself on the left side to the 20 and upended inside the 20 at about the 17-yard line. That's going to be just short of the first down marker.
Yeah, right. He's right at it. It was definitely a draw right up front on that one. You could tell he took the ball and immediately ran it. So it's going to be third and one
and a yard to go. 7:10 and counting in the fourth quarter. Carthage leading 28-21. Glad you've joined us for a thriller here at Vernon Newsom Stadium in Mansfield. All right, Argyle up to the line of scrimmage, third and one. They go to their jumbo package. T formation behind Awney in the backfield. Handoff goes to the running back, and he is stuffed at the line of scrimmage. I don't think he got it. He did pick up some yardage, but I think he's going to be just a tad short, I believe.
One of them linebackers they brought in, those ones that have been playing havoc on defense, and it is, they're going to measure it and see what it is. 6:40 left.
Yeah, just another good job there by the defense. You know, they got in their jumbo package, and our linebackers filled the hole. Didn't have a whole lot of penetration by our defensive line. Made a good tackle there. Looks like they're probably going to be maybe about a half a yard short.
Yeah, I can assure you they are short. It's just going to be by how much here. It's going to be fourth down and less than a yard for Argyle at inside our 22-yard line. They are short by about a half yard, more than the length of a football. So fourth and a half yard for Argyle at the Carthage 22.
Well, I'm
fourth and a yard.
We will end up all on the line of scrimmage. We just make sure if he breaks free that somebody's there to tackle him. That's happened to us earlier this year where we got in the line of scrimmage and they went through the line of scrimmage and there was nobody there left.
Maybe look for a play action pass as well.
All right, Awney under center. T formation behind him in the backfield, fourth down and less than a yard. Here's Awney, play action fake. He's going to run it himself around the right side, and he's got the first down at the 19-yard line. So he picked up a couple of yards to the 19, first and 10.
Yeah, he faked up the middle and then rolled to the outside and just had enough for a first down, just quite enough.
6:28 left. We're clicking to a 28-21 lead.
And Argyle has just such a great offense with their quarterback, and they're able to run the ball a little bit better than they were in the first half. They got good receivers. I mean, they just have a real good offense.
All right, we're going to give him 3 to the 18-yard line. So it's now 1st and 10 for Argyle at the 18. Boy, that was a big, big 15-yard penalty a couple of plays ago against the Bulldogs. 1st and 10 for Argyle. Here's a snap back in the Wildcat to the running, to the wideout, and he goes inside the 10 to the 9-yard line. That was the wideout, Ian Sadler, the sophomore wideout, and he takes it for 4 yards down to the 9.
Yeah, they're just going to probably run this thing. Unless we stuff them and make them have a 3rd and long, they're going to run this thing with 5:48. We do have time on the clock. We do have an offense. But defense has really had won the battle a while ago until a stupid play.
All right, now 2nd down and 6 at the Carthage 9. Handoff goes to the running back. Eveleth going to his left. And nothing doing this time. It's going to be a loss as he is pushed back. And they're going to spot it at about the 10. That's going to be a loss of 1, making it now 3rd down and 7 at the 10.
3rd and 7, and this defense playing, you know, they've got a field goal kicker. They could have an option to kick a field goal, but they don't know if they'll ever get the ball back.
Yeah, we've done a great job tonight of putting them in 3rd down situations, even 4th down. They're 2-for-2 on 4th down tonight as well.
3rd down and 7, 3rd and 7 for Argyle. Ball on the left hash, 3rd and 7 at our 10-yard line. Looked like they were going to snap it. Now they look over to the sideline. Down to 8 seconds on the play clock. Snap back to Awney in the gun. Now he's being rushed. Now he gets away. He throws to the left side. It's caught there. And that great one-on-one tackle immediately at the 5-yard line. It's going to bring up 4th down at the 5-yard line. A great tackle there by Michi Bowman.
Michi Bowman put his pads on him hard. That boy had a little tough time getting up. This is a big play here.
Yeah, and we actually almost had him sacked there in the backfield, and he was able to elude it, which is how good Austin Uni is at the quarterback. He has great feet and was able to find a receiver down there at the 5-yard line.
All right, it's 4th and 2 for Argyle at the Carthage 5-yard line. 4:15 to play in the ball game. 4th and 2 for Argyle at the Bulldog 5.
Somebody
and they've got
a play.
Jumbo package in there. Double tight end formation. T formation behind Awney. 4th down and 2. Hand. No, Awney keeps it himself. Awney going to run it himself to the right. He's headed toward the end zone flag, and he's into the end zone, but there is a flag.
That's an area of holding. Got to be. Or it could be pass interference against us because they were. And so it is. Looks like they're celebrating.
All right, a 5-yard run by Awney. And that makes it now 28-27.
You know, they're putting the ball in his hands. He's their playmaker, and they're putting the ball in his hands.
All right. 3:58 left. Got plenty of time. Whoever has the ball last will win this game. And thank goodness we possibly may have it last.
All right, big extra point coming up here by Argyle. Headland, the sophomore, to kick it. There's a snap. The kick is away, and it is good, and we're tied up 28-28, 3:58 to play in the ball game. Bulldogs will get the ball back here in the fourth quarter. Don't leave us. We'll be back right after this.
Have you visited Carthage Furniture lately? Carthage Furniture is the huge store behind the car wash on West Panola. Monty Bacon and his fine staff offer you a large selection of Ashley and Lane recliners. With more than 40 in stock, you have a great selection of colors, styles, and sizes starting at $299. Monty suggests you sit in the all-new high-back, wing-back Lane recliner starting at just $299. For the big man, your recliner starting at only $599. Carthage Furniture, the huge store behind the car wash on West Panola.
For 28 years, Panola National Bank has been an active partner in our community, working in civic organizations, schools, and churches, helping Panola County and its citizens with their financial needs. Community banking is basic to America, and we're proud of our success. As the Bulldogs, Bearcats, Tigers, Yellow Jackets, and Mustangs realize goals with teamwork, we at Panola National Bank rely on our team members. We invite you to come in and meet them. As a reminder, we open a little earlier and stay a little later for your convenience. Member FDIC and an equal housing lender.
Austin Awney on 4th down and 2 from the Bulldog 5. Power package with a T formation behind him, 3 running backs, and he faked it and took it in himself. Then they go deep with a kickoff, and they kick it out of the end zone. So the Bulldogs will have it 1st and 10 at our own 20.
Well, this is really what we wanted. We wanted the ball in our hands with the chance to win it.
And, you know, good teams win these situations. Of course, all we need is a field goal. And we do have a field goal kicker. So
yeah, and that win is blown in, and we are going into the win now. So.
And so, you know, the way we've run the ball in this half, I would think we'd kind of stick to that, but we'll see.
Yeah, the wind has picked up. It appears, looking at the flags here in the end zone to our right, that the wind has picked up. All right, Bogan shoots under center. Bogan shoots, hand off Pipkin. Pipkin going left. Pipkin wrapped up for no gain at the 20-yard line.
Well, they're daring us to throw it. I mean, to run, throw it, because they're lining up eight or nine in the box, and they're wanting us to throw the ball. And that time, their linebackers filled the holes like they should.
Second and 10 for Carthage at the 20. If you've just joined us, Carthage taking advantage of some Argyle turnovers, built a 21-3 lead. Argyle came back to tie it up 21-all. Carthage with a 28-21 lead. Argyle has just tied it up again. Snap back to Bogan, shoots in the gun. Here comes the screen pass. It's caught by Pipkin. Pipkin trying to get loose, and he cannot. It's going to be about a 2 or 3 yard gain. Boy, I tell you what, they defensed that one extremely well and limit us to 3 yards. It's now going to be 3rd and 7.
You know, I think that we didn't follow our blocking. Tevin didn't follow his blocking right. He had some to the outside, looks like. But the guy from the pursuit on the inside is the one, when he cut inside, got him.
3rd and 7, 2:55 to play in the ball game. 3rd and 7 for Carthage at our own 23-yard line. Argyle with the momentum. Boy, we need a big play to get the momentum back. Nothing else to keep the football. Snap back to Bogan, shoots in the gun. Hey, Bogan shoots, wants to throw it left, and he throws it, and it's over the head of the intended receiver out at the 42-yard line. That was Tasker Shannon, and it will be 4th down, and we'll have to kick it with 2:35 to go.
Yeah, and that clock stops on that missed pass. So surely we're not going to go for a – with them having a field goal kicker like they got, we're going to have to kick this thing.
Tasker got his hands up, and it just kind of went right through as he was turning around on the poster out there. And, you know, he would have got the first down if he'd been able to catch the ball.
But it would have been a spectacular grab. Pretty well defended that time by Argyle. And the Bulldogs are going to have to kick it away. Line of scrimmage is the 23, kicking into the breeze. Head high snap. Rugby-style kick.
Good kick.
Pretty good
down,
kick into the
down.
Wind. Hits at the 49-yard line to the 45, and is going to be down at the 45-yard line, 28 plus 3, a 33-yard kick. Argyle has it. 2:24 to play in the game. 2 timeouts, and the wind at their back.
Yeah, and they got a kicker, too, that can kick the ball pretty well. So we need to stop them right here, keep them from getting in our end of the field.
1st and 10 for Argyle at their 44. Oh, for a turnover here.
Somebody needs to make a play.
Yep, a tip pass and a pick six.
And our defense has been our strong point all year, so, you know, we got them on the field now with 2:24 left. The game is tied up 28-28.
All right, Oni. But our defense has been on the field a lot in this ballgame. Snap back to Oni. Oni hands off to the running back. Running back Eveleth trying to go left, and he's hit hard and stopped at the 45-yard line. A gain of about 1 on the play. They may give him 2. They do.
If I had to say who was the most physical tonight, we are. We hit him with Jackson again, laid him out.
Especially on defense.
Mm-hmm.
2 minutes to go in the ball game. Clock rolling. They've got 2 timeouts left. 2nd down and 8 for Argyle at their 46. He throws to the right, is caught at the 50, and he's down to our 45-yard line before he is stopped. That's going to be a gain of 9. They stop the clock, and that's a 1st down.
They'll stop the clock while they set the chains. Defense needs to be ready because they're going to come to the line of scrimmage quick. We need a play right here by somebody on defense, because I don't like our chances in overtime, you know, because of the way they're moving the ball and we haven't.
All right, 1st and 10 at the Carthage 45.
Clock running, 1:33 left.
All right, down to 5 seconds on the play clock. Down to 3, and they have to use a timeout. That leaves them with 1, I believe. All right, we'll take a timeout. 1:27 to play in the fourth quarter. 28-28 tie. Back from Mansfield right after this.
When you're looking for high-quality personal care from people on whom you can depend, choose East Texas Medical Center in Carthage. The employees are people you know and trust. ETMC Carthage, an East Texas medical tradition. Here when you need them, yet able to refer you when circumstances arise. ETMC Carthage, a tradition of excellence, enhanced by becoming part of a system. ETMC Carthage, proud sponsors of the Carthage High School Battling Bulldogs.
Just in time, Sanitation Services has just what you need for residential, construction, commercial, oil field, and special events. From portable toilets to roll-off dumpsters, storage containers, holding tanks, and hand washing stations, Just in Time Sanitation can help. Dial 903-693-9991. Our commitment is to serve you. Serving all of East Texas and Western Louisiana, Just in Time Sanitation Service has what you need to keep it clean and functioning. 903-693-9991. It will be done just in time.
Well, I don't have time of possession, but I can tell you Argyle has run 68 plays, Carthage 43. So our defense has been on the field a lot here in this ballgame. 127 to go in the fourth quarter. We need a big play here from our defense. Here's Oni rolling to his right. He wants to throw. He throws, and it's caught, and then he runs out of bound quickly at the 43-yard line. That's going to be just a short gain of 2 yards.
Yeah, but he got out of bounds, and the clock stops. So they've got a field goal kicker that can probably kick it, what, 35, 40 yards?
I think this year his longest, he's 16 of 18 in field goals, and his longest is a 42. But now he has a win behind his back here at Mansfield tonight.
All right, second down and eight. Second and eight for Argyle at the Carthage 43. Oni in the gun, snap back to him. Pretty good protection, great protection. Now he's going to run with it. He's going to his right. And he's going to be stopped at the 37-yard line. He did not get out of bounds, and he did not get a first down.
And I don't know if he was tackled or he went down again, Larry.
Looks like he went down.
You know, that's going to cost him some time right there.
All right, 60 seconds to go, 60 seconds and counting here. They're down to one timeout, and, of course, you want to save that to get your field goal unit on the field. Third down and two for Argyle. At the Carthage 37, third down and two, power formation. Hand off to the running back. He goes up the middle. He's got the first down to our 34. That stops the clock with 42 seconds left.
And so we need them. They may throw it now because of the incompletion would stop the clock.
Well, they're not really trying anything deep downfield. They're trying to go short and everything. So we had to call a timeout because we were shuffling players in on the field. We had too many on the field, and our guy was trying to run the ball, get a quick snap right there, so we had to take a timeout.
So we'll go back. The score is 28-28. We'll be back after this.
If you don't have an oil well, you need to get one so Ricky and Casey Bagley at Bagley Well Services can help you take care of it. Bagley Well Services is a complete service, hookups, pipelines, maintenance, backhoe, dozer, and pipe hauling. Bagley Well Service, one call, does it all. 903-622-4122. So if you have an oil well, let Bagley Well Services do the work for you. 903-622-4122.
Are you or a loved one suffering from a life-limiting illness? Let Heart's Way Hospice be there for you. Our experienced and compassionate team of nurses, social workers, home health aides, and chaplains will help guide you through the difficult days ahead. For more information, please call our office in Carthage, 903-690-9924. You will not walk alone with Heart's Way Hospice.
Okay, 28-28 tie here in Mansfield, 37 seconds to go. Argyle, one timeout left, first and 10 at the Carthage 35. Snap back to Oni in the gun. Oni going to run the quarterback draw, and he's being wrapped up and stopped at the 35-yard line. The clock continues to run. Remember, they've only got one timeout left. No gain for Oni. We're now down to 25 seconds and counting left to go in the ball game. Oni up to the line of scrimmage. The Argyle Eagles are second down and 10, 18 seconds left. Snap back to Oni. Oni throws over the middle. It's caught by the receiver. He's going to be short of the first down, however, at the 26-yard line. 9 seconds, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4. He's short of the first down. 4 seconds to go, and they call timeout with 3 seconds left. 3 seconds left on the clock, and we're going to have a 42-yard field goal, make it 43 yards coming up after the timeout. We'll take a break here in Mansfield.
This is Walter Sparks at XL Ford in Carthage. For the best selection of cars and trucks in the Ark-La-Tex, power, performance, economy, there's nothing like a Ford. XL Ford in Carthage has the best parts, service department in the Ark-La-Tex. If you haven't driven a Ford lately, let me personally invite you to come by and take a test drive. Check us out on the internet. We will match or beat any deal in the Ark-La-Tex. Still on the South Loop and still number one. God bless America and Semper Fi.
Well, Cole Headland's long field goal this year is 42 yards. And if he kicks this one, he'll have a new long for the year. It'll be 43. And Argyle will advance to meet the Gilmer Buckeyes. Evidently, I think Gilmer, we've got a final on that.
Is yes.
That, okay. They'll advance to meet Gilmer next week. Only 3 seconds left. Only 3 seconds left in the ball game. And Carthage now calls a timeout. Carthage calls a timeout to give him a chance to think about it. We'll take another break here.
At Citizens Bank in Carthage, we want you to not only feel like a customer, but like one of our extended family. Citizens Bank would like to help you build that dream home, buy a first home, or relocate to a larger residence. The friendly loan staff at Citizens Bank can make those dreams come true. Come by our Carthage location and speak to Sonia Hathorn about your options. Citizens Bank is an equal housing lender, member FDIC.
'Cause we stand for your success.
Hello, this is Melinda Leslie with Copper Falls & Company, a full-service jewelry and gift store located on the Carthage Square. We also buy gold and silver. Gold has never been this high. Take advantage of these high prices. Come by to see us. Let us weigh your gold and silver, make you an offer. You're under no obligation. We understand that a lot of people want save their jewelry in a lockbox for their children or grandchildren.
All right, 43-yard field goal coming up to win it for Argyle. 3 seconds left. This will be the last play of the game. We await the snap. There's the snap. The kick is away, and left. This one is going to be no good. He missed it to the left. He missed it to the left, and we will go into overtime here. Headland pulled it to the left at an angle back to the right. It was a line drive kick, and we will have overtime here in Mansfield.
Now, what happens in overtime, you get the ball at the 25-yard line, and you get a chance to score. And then the other team gets the chance to score from the same thing you do. Whoever loses the flip chooses which end of the field, or chooses whether the one who wins the flip decides whether they want to wait and see what the other team's done, or they want to take it and go on in. And then I think at the second one, if you score, you have to go for two, don't you?
It's either on the second or the third one.
I think it's the third one you go for two.
Okay. I think it's the third one you go for two. Well, Mark, you said you said earlier, I don't like our chances in overtime. Let's just face it, we've been outplayed since the 10:36 mark of the second half, when we scored on a 6-yard run by Trent Jackson to take a 21-3 lead. Then Argyle came back and made it 21-10 on a 1-yard run by Bossal. That's the drive in which we retaliated, picked up a unsportsmanlike conduct call that gave them a great chance to score. And then on the ensuing kickoff, Tasker Shannon fumble. They got the field goal just before the end of the half to make it 21-13. And I tell you what, that the Bulldogs pull this one out. I'm going to count up the number of plays again. All right, we're going to have the flip out of the middle of the field. Go ahead,
yeah,
Mark.
And we had that penalty there too on that last drive when they scored on what was they called a taunting call, that which would have put them in fourth down long situation. I think the key so far was our defense stepped up and played good right there at the end. And I was worried because we were 0-for-2 on fourth down. They were 3-for-3, scored a touchdown. They were good in their third down conversions as well.
Well, we're having the coin toss at the middle of the field. Both coaches are out there. Ricky Ingram out for the Bulldogs along with Scott Surratt. And out there is Tom Rogers along with Karsten Bossal.
Well,
there's two brothers there, Karsten Bossal and the Chad Bossal.
If you want to, if you win the flip, you got the choice here to take defense first. And it's kind of hard after our defense has been on the field so long to put them right back out there. But you really got to see what you got to get at the end of the situation.
And our defense has been our strong point out of the year, and they pulled through then. We're 1-for-1 in overtime game this year. First district game of the year, we beat Pittsburgh in overtime, so we'll see what the coin flip says. We get the ball first.
And we're going to take it with the wind. And then we'll go down here into the wind, won't we? It'll switch.
They'll just flop over, and then they'll go with the wind as well.
No, I'm talking about after that first one's over with, if it's tied.
I think that's right.
You switch ends of the field.
All right, so we go to overtime here. What would have been a winning field goal for Argyle, a 43-yarder, was missed by Cole Headland.
Since we played five teams, including this team, this year in the top 10, that we would have that enough experience to go ahead and win this ball game. But stopping their quarterback is going to be a formidable task.
Again, we forced him into some tough situations. We forced him to scramble, but we have yet to sack him. And here in the second half, they started going. They've been running the ball more effectively than they did in the first half. Okay, Bulldogs on offense now to start overtime. Bogan shoots under center. A receiver split to each side. Pipkin is the tailback. And we've got a double tight end formation. Here's handoff to Pipkin. Pipkin up the middle. Now he cuts back to the left, and he's inside. Now he's down to the 20 for a five-yard gain.
Yeah, that was designed to go to the right, but he cut it back to the left. And got good yardage out of it. Those linebackers have usually been filling the hole when he gets past the line of scrimmage.
And, you know, and time is not a factor here in overtime as well, right. So there's no time on the clock.
That's true. All right, so we're in overtime here at Mansfield. The winner will face the Gilmer Buckeyes next week in the Region 2 Championship. All right, Pope split left, Shannon to the right. Here's Bogan shoots, three-step drop. Going for the end zone for Shannon. This one is incomplete. Just let him miss a little bit too much. Not much, but just a little bit.
Mm.
He did have a step on the defender there.
All right, that puts us in a third and long. Not a whole lot, third and five. But we need to get a good push here on the offensive line and get a first down here.
Question is, if we don't get it, you know, will Scott go for the field goal? Or we go for it on fourth down.
Right.
That's what we pay him the bucks for.
That's right.
And the buck stops there.
And the buck stops there, too, is right. All right. Two receivers to the right, Shannon to the left. Now Pope split out right, goes motion left. Here's Bogan shoots, under center, options. Here's a throw. It's caught by Pope. Pope trying to get the first down, and I think he did, but it was very, very close. Very, very close as to where they're going to spot it. They're going to spot him short. He needed 5 yards, and he got 4.
Well, this is decision time here because we do have a field goal kicker.
Boy, I want to tell you, he really –
Jumbo package. We're going to go
jumbo package here. You think he could have got it if he had cut up field? He was trying to get to the outside, and boy, their tackler. What'd you say?
I think if he'd have held his arm out, the position of the ball.
Okay, we're taking a chance here. Fourth down and one in overtime, and we go with the jumbo package. An empty backfield behind Bogan shoots. Bogan shoots this time. Rolls out. He throws. It is incomplete for Cage. Incomplete, and Argyle holds. And now they will get the football, and all they have to do is kick a field goal to win it. All right, we went with the jumbo, what was appearing to be the jumbo package, but then Jackson and became a wing to the left, and we had an empty backfield. Bogenschutz rolled to his right, tried to hit Cage. They had good coverage on it, and Cage was hit just as the ball got there, incomplete pass.
Well, our two seniors is who we went to in those plays, and you know, if you're going to lose a state championship run like we're doing, I mean, like we've done, this is the way to do it. Make somebody go overtime on us.
All right, now Oney in the gun. Snap back to him, hand off to Eveleth. Eveleth going to the right, and he's to the 20, inside the 15, down to about the 14-yard line. A gain of 11 for Eveleth.
I don't know if I'd kick field goal right now. Got the, you know. Because you risk a fumble, you risk all kinds of situations.
You know, when you get it at the 25 with the wind behind you, Headland has enough leg to kick it without even running a play. But now for sure can hit it from here. First and 10 for Argyle. They've really got the advantage now. All they need is a field goal in overtime. Carthage did not score in overtime. First and 10 from the Carthage 14. Hand off to Eveleth. Eveleth trying the middle. Now he's hemmed in. And let's see, is going to get about 1 yard to the 13.
And put it in the middle of the field. So we got a man down. Let's see what we got there. He's down. We might as well go to commercial break. Scores 28-28. We'll be back.
What's your biggest concern when the weather is cold? A problem with your heater or electrical system? Well, Hal and Bruce Whitaker are the names you know and trust to calm your fears. Hal and Bruce at Hal's AC and Electric know electricity. They'll help you stay warm and keep your systems running properly. Whether it's residential, commercial, industrial, or oil field work, Hal's AC and Heating is the one to call at 903-693-7451. Quick, dependable service. They sell Amana, Train, and Goodman, but service all brands. Hal and Bruce Whitaker, the names that you know and trust.
Well, it's down to an overtime chance for them. Dakota Hart comes off the field, looks like he got a bum knee, and the Dogs have made a heck of a run, and it don't look bright now. The game's not over, but
it does not look good. Second down and 8 for Argyle. We're in overtime. Second and 8 at the Carthage 13 yard line. The Carthage did not score in overtime. Argyle only needs a field goal. Hand off to Eveleth. Eveleth going to his right. He's to the 10 and is brought down at the 10-yard line. They make it the 9. That's going to be a gain of 4 more for Eveleth.
Yep, we can't stop that this half. That's run us all half. But
the question now is a 3rd and 5. You want to go ahead and try and kick the field goal in case you have a botched snap?
Right.
Or wait till it on 4th down?
And they're going to evidently go for a first down here. It's 3rd and 4. Oh, for a turnover here. 3rd and 4 for Argyle at our 9 in overtime. Hand off to Eveleth. Eveleth gets it to the middle of the field. Gets it to the middle of the field at the 10. And here comes the field goal unit to win it for Argyle.
And just like Surratt said, you know, the seniors this year don't care if we won it 3 years in a row. They wanted to win it their senior year. And it doesn't look real good here. But things can be blocked.
And, you know, we do have a timeout, and I'll probably look for Surratt maybe to call a timeout again to ice the kicker.
Oh, here. All right, it's 4th down. It's going to be a 27-yard field goal attempt, and we call a timeout to give them a chance to think it over. We'll take a break.
Attention hunters, Bill's Meat Market in Carthage is ready to process your deer, wild hog, or elk, providing regular cuts, smoked sausage, even summer sausage and jerky. Remember, by law, you must deliver your kill skinned, gutted, and in an ice chest. Bill says it's time to order those holiday hams and turkeys, smoked, fried, or fresh. Catering is also available for the holiday parties. Bill's Meat Market and Catering, 1317 West Panola, 693-6122. Bill's in Carthage. They have great food.
Well, the championship run of the Bulldogs could be coming to a close here. Argyle in overtime after Carthage failed to score is going to have a 27-yard field goal to win it and advance to face the Gilmer Buckeyes next week in the regional championship. Argyle trailed at one time 21-3. Boy, you've got to hand it to them. They have come back. Of course, it's not over with yet, but things don't look good now. 27-yard field goal coming up. There's a snap. It's a low snap. The kick is away, and it is no good. He missed it to the left. He missed it to the left, and we will go to second overtime here.
Scott Surratt's got a rabbit foot in his pocket. I'm going to tell you, he dodged the bullet. Now, this time, we need to take the ball and run it.
We'll be on defense this time, and they'll be on offense first. So.
Wow. Hedlund has missed 2 field goals. Now, the first one was a 43-yarder, but that was 27 yards. Carthage in overtime first with the football and went for it on 4th down and 1. We failed to pick up a first down. Therefore, Argyle only needing a field goal, took it from the 25 down to the 10, tried a 27-yard field goal, and Hedlund has now pulled 2 to the left with the win here in first in the fourth quarter in the final play of the game, and now in overtime. And
now,
we're going to go to the second overtime.
Larry, we lost Dakota Hart a while ago to an injury. And I don't know, he come to the side. He did put a little weight on it, but we got to remember, we've got a new defensive lineman that's got to come in and play some big shoes.
It's Graves. Greg
Graves, okay.
He you know, has a little bit more speed on the outside end, and hopefully that can help us because they've been trying to run us outside the tackles on the running back, and our quarterback's trying to run inside the tackles.
Okay, so our defense was on the field. Now they go back out on the field. Snap back to Oney in the gun. Oney looking right. He throws right. It's caught by Rossell. Rossell at the 20, down to the 16 for a 9-yard gain.
Yeah, we don't need to give up a touchdown here, period, because that means we'll have to score one.
They're just running those little under-inside routes on the receivers.
All right, second and one for Argyle at the Carthage 16. Oney going to be in the gun. Boy, what an advantage in a game like this to have a senior quarterback. And they're down now to 5 seconds on the play clock. A little bit of confusion on their part. Snap back to Oney. Oney looking right. He throws right. It's caught out there, and he is going to be tackled. He's going to push out of bounds at the 9-yard line for a first down.
All right. Well, that's the. There's only one 9.5 is how far you'd have to go if you didn't have 9. Otherwise, you'd be you could get a first down. So our defense can string them out here because they've got to go the full distance almost to the first down.
And we're playing them off on the receiver's position, and we don't want them to go further on us, but now we're playing up a little bit more closer.
Oney, 7 out of 7 on his last 7 attempts. Okay, Oney hands off to the running back coming left to the 5, and he is into the end zone for a touchdown. That is a 5-yard touchdown run for Ian Sadler. Sadler with a 5-yard touchdown run. And Argyle now leads it 34-28.
Well, they've been eating us up on that outside all second half, and why not go back to the well?
And he made a good cut inside, following his blockers to get in there in that space and, you know, take it in for the touchdown.
Was that 5 yards?
Nine.
Okay, excuse me. 9 for Sadler. Okay, we wait the extra point. Low snap. He kicks it, and it is going to be good this time. And so now Argyle leads it 35-28. Here in overtime. All right, the Bulldogs get the football now.
Yes, and that well, we know what we have to do. And you know Surratt, if he scores a touchdown, he may go for 2.
He's going for 2. That'd be my guess.
Because his defense has been on the field a long time.
Yeah, and we really hadn't stopped him here, even in the over right there before the half and in the first overtime possession in there in the second. You know, our defense is probably getting worn out. They're close to running, you know, probably 90 plays in this game.
So our offense has got to be fresh.
We just got to execute and do what we did there in the first half when we got up 21-3.
All right, the Bulldog offense now out on the field. Treading in over, in the second overtime, 35-28. Bogan shoots under center. Hands off to Pipkin. Pipkin up the middle. 20, 15, 10, 5, toward the goal line. Pipkin in for the touchdown. Pipkin goes 25 yards to make it 35-34.
Wow. Completely changed situation. Now what you do? Oh, well, Gonzalez is coming out. So it's decision time, you know. You're playing another top 10 team.
Well, now he's walking back. Looks like Scott's rethinking what if he wants to go for 2 or go for 1.
Well, this would be for all the marbles right
and
here.
And, boy, this is really why he's paid the big bucks.
He's probably going to call a timeout here.
And I would. There's no way, nothing to run down to wait to where you'd call a timeout.
Yeah, we're going to call a timeout.
Yeah, timeout called. All right, we'll take a break.
All right,
break here from Mansfield.
Basic Energy Services of East Texas serves East Texas and Northern Louisiana with quality, dependable oil field service. Their services include acidizing, cementing work over rigs, and hauling salt water. If you have an oil well in East Texas, you need to know Basic Energy Services of East Texas. Basic Energy Services, proud supporters of all our area schools.
There's never been a better time to buy a new Camry than right now at Marshall Toyota. I'm Danny Cole, and today you can buy a 2011 Camry LE fully loaded with a $1,000 rebate and zero interest. If you lease, you'll get a special lease payment. Our selection is good, our staff is great, and ready to give you more details. Our service after the sale is second to none. Call us at 903-938-9026, on the web at marshalltoyota.com, or better yet, visit us at 5015 East End Boulevard South in Marshall.
All right, we're back at Mansfield in the second overtime. Both teams have scored. Argyle scored first, kicked the extra point. Carthage has just scored on the first play of their possession in second overtime, 25-yard run by Tevin Pipkin. And the Bulldogs sent out Jimmy Gonzalez originally to go for the extra point kick. And now it appears that the Bulldogs are going to go for two to try to win it.
They may run that play that we're going to run against.
Carthage going for two to try to win it. It appears to be a little bit of confusion, I would think.
Maybe they're going to snap something funny here.
Appears to be some confusion by the Bulldogs. 18 seconds left on the play clock. Pipkin is not in there. Now he comes in.
What's he doing?
And I think Surratt is saying to take the penalty here because we had some confusion. And we take a penalty.
And also I think what we were trying to do is see how they might set up and what formation we had. And this might back us up to give us more room. Maybe we want to pass the ball.
Right.
But, you know, it could come back to hurt us.
So the Bulldogs.
We're going to kick it now. Looks like.
All right. After the penalty, and it appeared we were going to go for two. It appeared that we had some confusion. We allowed the clock to run out to take the delay of game, and now we're going to kick it to tie it up.
Yep, it's somewhere.
But got to make this one here. We await the snap. Good snap. The kick is away, and it appears. No, it hit the upright. It is no good. Argyle wins the football game. It hit the left upright, and Argyle wins it 35-34.
Well,
hit the left upright.
What a run. What a run we've had, guys. Can't complain. A penalty cost us this game, I think, late in the ball game. Unsportsmanlike penalty.
Well, I mean, I think it's one of those things where, you know, we didn't stop them on some third down situations. You know, they were 3-for-3 on fourth down. You hate to lose it like that, you know, on an extra point like that. I think what Surratt was doing right there was he wanted to see how they lined up, and then if he didn't like it, we just take the delay game and kick the extra point. But, you know, we knew going in this season that we had a lot of holes to fill with the quarterback position, the running back, and the receiver, what we lost last year. We had a few holes on defense. Defense, we knew we was going to be our strong point. And we had a lot of kids step up this year to, you know, fulfill those holes on offense. You know, we weren't quite as what we are polished have we been in the past on the offensive side of the ball. And you hate something to happen like that where it comes down to an extra point and double overtime. But, you know, we had a lot of kids step up. And, you know, we're going to have a lot of good kids back next year. We'll have our quarterback and running back position filled. We're going to find some receivers. We'll have to do a lot of work there on the offensive line. We had a lot of first-year starters on the offensive line as well and on the defense as well. Well, we'll have some more defensive lineman jobs to fill as well. But our JV group this year, I think they went 6-2.
And we're missing eight of their ball players.
And then our freshman group went undefeated. I think there's some kids there that probably step up. But, you know, you hate to come down to an extra point, miss extra point like that. But, you know, we had a tough time stopping Argyle, and there's nothing to hang our heads about. I think, you know, we played about as good as we could play with a few mistakes. You know, we did create some turnovers, scored 21 points off the turnovers. But, you know, that's how things fall, you know. I mean, we lost by 1 point to a good Argyle team. They'll have their hands full next week as they play Gilmer as well. So, and we knew if we won this game, we had another big game next week as well against Gilmer.
Yeah, and our coaches got us prepared. They got us prepared to win this game. And we were with one extra point away. We lost two games this year by an extra point, missing an extra point. Chapel Hill, which was number one in the state at the time, and still number one. But we got to take our hat off to our coaches. They had a young crew again this year, and they made something of them.
Yes, the kind of like what they did last year. A lot of those kids on the last year team were first-year starters. They were, you know, overachievers, especially that offensive line. But we placed, you know, we faced a lot of good teams this year, like you said, Mark, Chapel Hill, Lindell, and we played Henderson. They were in the top 10. We beat them, and we played Gilmer the week before that. They were in the top 10. Lost there with, you know, a last-second field goal with 9 seconds left. But we'll go ahead and turn over Larry.
There for your wrap-up.
Stats and his wrap-up.
Friday night at Newsom Stadium in Mansfield, Texas, the championship run of the Carthage Bulldogs came to a close as the Argyle Eagles knocked off the Bulldogs 35-34 in double overtime. Headland gave Argyle a 3-0 lead, and they were on the board first, 6:24 to play in the first quarter. Blake Bogenschutz with a 1-yard quarterback sneak gave the Bulldogs the lead. It was 7-3 Dogs, 1:35 to play in the first. And then a special play by the Dogs. Bogenschutz, a backwards pass to Cage. Cage back to Bogenschutz on another backward pass. And then Bogenschutz threw it downfield, a 50-yard touchdown pass, a spectacular grab by Ed Pope. And the Dogs were leading 14-3, 11:49 to play in the first half. Then the Bulldogs, after a fumble recovery on the ensuing kickoff at the 17-yard line, they converted a 6-yard run by Trent Jackson, and the Dogs seemed to be in total control. It was 21-3 Carthage, 10:36 to play in the second quarter. But back came the Argyle Eagles. They scored on a 1-yard run by Chad Bossell. Bossell with the run made it 21-10, 7:09 to play until halftime. And then on the ensuing kickoff, a big play here. We fumbled the kickoff, and they converted that into a 24-yard field goal, and so Argyle was back within 8, 21-13 at halftime. Then they tied it up in the third quarter, 7:30 to go on a 20-yard pass from Austin Ani to Bossell. The two-point conversion made it 21-all, and that was the score with, again, 7:30 to play in the third quarter. The Bulldogs, however, came back once again. They took the lead on a 1-yard run by Trent Jackson, his second TD of the night. It was 28-21 Carthage with 11:16 to go in the fourth quarter. Austin Ani, their fine senior quarterback, tied it up with 3:58 to go in the fourth at 28-all. In overtime, Carthage did not score in the first overtime, and Argyle had a field goal attempt, a 27-yarder that could have won it on the final play of the first overtime. It sailed wide to the left, so we went to the second overtime. Ian Sadler gave Argyle the lead in overtime on a 9-yard run after the kick. It was 35-28. And on the first play for the Bulldogs in second overtime, Tevin Pipkin scored on a 25-yard run to make it 35-34. The Bulldogs on the extra point appeared to be lining up to go for two. They elected to take a delay of game penalty that moved the football back 5 yards. Instead of kicking the extra point at the 10-yard line, we kicked it from the 15. And the extra point attempt by Jimmy Gonzalez hit the left upright. It did not go through. It bounced away. Argyle wins it 35-34 in a thriller. Here are the stats. Argyle with 24 first downs, Carthage with 15. And on the ground, Argyle had a big edge, 238 to 133. Through the air, the Bulldogs were 11 of 21 for 162. Argyle 18 of 31 for 169. So the total yardage, Argyle with a pretty good edge, 407 to 295. Carthage with one turnover, Argyle had three. Argyle is now 12-1. They'll advance to face the Gilmer Buckeyes, who were undefeated for the year, in the regional championship game next week. Carthage season ends with a record of 9-4, and this is the final game, as it turns out, for a number of young men for Carthage who are seniors this year. They include Ed Pope, Michi Bowman, Ricky Ingram, Tasker Shannon, Clint Cage, Chris Walton, Brandon Friedman, Ramon Bridges, Chad Adams, Eric Ware, Justin Williams, Bry Anderson, Mitchell Kinman, Morgan Jeans, Johnny Odom, Greg Brantley, LZ Hicks, and Dakota Hart. Those are the seniors this year for the Bulldogs. What a run for this class. Three straight championships, state championships, but the 2011 season in short here in Mansfield. And the final score, once again, in double overtime, Newsom Stadium in Mansfield. In double overtime, Argyle 35 and Carthage 34. For your Sports Beat station, I'm Larry Allen.
You've been listening to Carthage.